For Columbus River Dragons Hockey. Tonight's presentation of River Dragons Hockey is brought to you in part by Pepsi, the official soft drink of the Columbus River Dragons. Zelmo Zipin, the official fuel provider of the River Dragons. Air Force Heating and Air, the official heating and air company of the River Dragons. And Country Inn and Suites, the official host hotel of the River Dragons. Now let's send it to the broadcast booth with the voice of the River Dragons, Tom Callahan.
Hello, everyone, and welcome into Columbus River Dragons Hockey. I'm Tom Callahan. Thank you so much for joining me here tonight as we're on the road this evening at the Winston-Salem Fairgrounds Annex. Boy, the last time the River Dragons were here, unfortunately, it was the end of their playoff push last season against these same Carolina Thunderbirds. So the River Dragons coming into this game here this evening, well, looking for revenge not only for last year, but also for last night. A tough, hard-fought battle between these two teams last night at the Columbus Civic Center. That was 1-0 River Dragons until the final minute of regulation. Then the Carolina Thunderbirds scored to tie it up, send it into the overtime. Yuri Pastuka getting the game-tying goal with the goaltender pulled and a 6-on-5 advantage. No scoring in the overtime. The River Dragons had a power play in the overtime. They could not cash in, and it goes to a shootout. It was there that the Thunderbirds scored on 2 out of 3 attempts, while the River Dragons were shut out on their 2 attempts. And so the extra point goes to the Thunderbirds, and that's where we enter tonight's matchup. The River Dragons are still in first place in the Continental Division. The Thunderbirds are still in second, but they are nip-tuck at one another's heels, as they were all last year. This is nothing new. These two teams have gone at it back and forth for quite some time. And, well, I mean, it should be no surprise if you followed the FBHL for really longer than 2 seconds. You kind of look at the standings, you see, hey, Binghamton, pretty dominant in the Empire. Then you look over and see Columbus and Carolina atop that Continental Division. The River Dragons come in at 7-1-1, 22 points on the year. That's an .815 win percentage, which is still the best in the FBHL. Carolina 5-2-2, 19 points and a .704 win percentage this year. A low scoring affair yesterday, maybe not something that River Dragons fans are accustomed to. As a matter of fact, until last night, the River Dragons had not scored less than 4 goals in any one game this season. Carolina, likewise, had been used to putting pucks in the net, but yesterday the teams clamped down defensively. Excellent goaltending performances all the way around, and it just became a game where, if you look at it from the standpoint of when two teams of similar skill go head-to-head, maybe you're going to get a run-and-gun game, maybe they'll open it up, but more often than not, what you get is a battle, and that's exactly what yesterday was. The teams had to scratch and claw for every inch that they got, whether it was an extra shot on goal, a rebound, or even keeping a puck in the zone. The teams had to work for it. Zone time, establishing that zone time, they had to work for it. It was not an easy game for either one of these two teams yesterday. And so right now, the two teams going through warm-up. We want to say hello to everybody joining us on our radio flagship station. 106.9 really rocks. And, of course, on our YouTube channel at Columbus River Dragons. We are pleased that you are here and want to remind everyone that the River Dragons will indeed be back home next on December 8th and 9th. And we're just going to party all weekend. December 8th is the mascot birthday party. That's right, both Torch and Scorch. We celebrate their birthdays December 8th. And then December 9th is the 5th anniversary party. Looking forward to that as well. Should be an awful lot of fun. In between, there's a road trip sandwiched in there to go take on the Blue Ridge Bobcats. Our first chance to take a look at Wytheville, Virginia. See what the setup is there. And we'll bring you those games as well. But right now, this is the most important thing at hand, is the River Dragons here trying to shake off the Black Friday shootout loss and come back, maybe get 3 points in regulation here tonight. We're going to talk about starting goaltenders. If there's any lineup changes, we're also going to get into that Zelmo Zipin out-of-town scoreboard as well. Plus, we have our customary chat with head coach Jerome Bichard. That's coming your way here in the Air Force Heating and Air pregame show, so stay tuned. Plenty more. This is Columbus River Dragons Hockey. Hey, sports fans, it's game time. There's no better time to make sure your heating and air system is working like it should. Air Force Heating and Air, the official AC sponsor of the Columbus River Dragons, is excited to offer you our special $79 tune-up. Call us today at 706-661-7242 or visit us at airforceheatingandair.com.
That's airforceheatingandair.com. We're always here when you need us. Air Force Heating and Air. License number PC0004272, EC0101216. It's the fifth anniversary season of Columbus River Dragons hockey, and RiverDragonsMerch.com has everything you need, including our new limited edition anniversary look. RDragonsMerch.com has something for all ages, with a variety of hats, shirts, jackets, and more. Plus, cool souvenir items like the always popular fan chains, pucks, and keychains. Want to order a gift for someone? We'll ship it for you. Just go online to RDragonsMerch.com.
At the Country Inn and Suites by Radisson, you'll enjoy comfortable accommodations close to Columbus State University, Fort Benning, and of course, the River Dragons games. Conveniently located at 1720 Fountain Court in Columbus, you'll be minutes away from all your favorite Columbus destinations. Free high-speed Wi-Fi and hot breakfast always available too. So whether you're staying for business or for pleasure, make your next stay in Columbus a comfortable one at the official hotel partner of the River Dragons, Country Inn and Suites by Radisson.
If you're looking for quality dental work, look no further than Largeman Dental in Columbus, the River Dragons' trusted oral care provider. Largeman Dental provides cleaning services, restorative work, cosmetics, prosthetics, and Invisalign braces too. Dr. Largeman has over 19 years of clinical experiences in all phases of dentistry and holds memberships in four different esteemed dental societies. Set your next appointment by calling 706-322-6581 or visit them online at largemandental.com.
Everybody out here crazy, crazy. Hail to the victor.
Welcome back here on Columbus River Dragons Hockey. Tom Callahan here with you. Thanks for joining us here. We are in Winston-Salem tonight for the back half of a home-and-home between the Columbus River Dragons and the Carolina Thunderbirds. Now, these two teams, no strangers, met each other last year several times. This year, 11 times, 5 in Columbus, 6 here in Carolina, including the last week of the regular season. They will meet 3 times. The first two will be right here at the Annex. And then the final game of the regular season back in Columbus on our fan appreciation night. Look, single game seats are on sale now already for the rest of the year. And by the way, that is our last family four-pack night of the year as well, co-sponsored by Kissin 99.3 and Chick-fil-A Midland. I would suggest you circle that on your calendar because, A, you're going to want to get your tickets now. B, I guarantee you it's going to have something to do with playoff standing. It may decide home ice advantage throughout the playoffs. It may decide home ice advantage throughout the Continental Division playoffs, at least. But these two teams always seem to be the teams that are destined to be battling it out on top heading into the postseason. And so hopefully the River Dragons, well, a lot of hockey to get to before we get all the way to April 13th. But I'll tell you what, this is the rivalry for the River Dragons. I think Mississippi is a good one. Maybe Baton Rouge could be a burgeoning rivalry for the River Dragons, but when it comes to just first word out of your mouth, if I ask you if you're a River Dragons fan, which team is it that sticks in your craw? I'm pretty much betting it's the Carolina Thunderbirds. So the two teams for the first time here tonight at the Annex, out there finishing up the warm-ups right now. River Dragons wearing their road whites. If you are watching on YouTube, those are just warm-up jerseys for the Thunderbirds. They will not be wearing those in the regular contest here tonight. We expect them to be in their customary reds, if not the black, on a Saturday night. But just a heads up. So if you are wondering, those are just this year's edition of the warm-up jerseys for the Carolina Thunderbirds. Wanted to make sure that we talked about that before we got too deep into things here. Want to remind you as well, the River Dragons Hockey is brought to you by Country Inn and Suites. They're the official host hotel of the Columbus River Dragons. By Pepsi, the official soft drink of the River Dragons. By Zelmo Zippin, the official fuel provider of the River Dragons. And this road trip, of course. And our pregame sponsor here, Air Force Heating and Air, the official heating and air company of the River Dragons. Columbus had its Tim Hortons win streak snapped at 4 games last night. Still only one loss in regulation, though, on the year. So if there is a consolation, it's that they pick up the point by getting it past regulation, although certainly disappointing the way things ended. And we are going to talk with head coach Jerome Bichard about the way the game went and then ending up getting into overtime. Be curious to get Boomer's take on that. And then, of course, jumping right back into it here this evening, which, by the way, we are headed for a 6:05 Eastern time start want to make sure that everybody knows that as well. We are going early on a Saturday night in Carolina. Their typical Saturday starts are 6:05 p.m. So we are right on time for that. As of now, anyway, we'll see how that all pans itself out. But barring any delays, should drop the puck on time. Warm-ups are about to come to an end. Let's talk a little bit about the lineup, shall we? For this evening's game for the River Dragons, no real changes. Still without Josh Petrantonio, the captain. Another rest day for him here on the weekend. And also still without Alex Basey. And that really sets the lineup for the River Dragons because Carson Andreoli remains on IR and is not eligible to come off IR until next week. So even if Andreoli is healthy, resumes skating whenever he's going to come back and be ready to go out there, he would not be able to participate in tonight's game regardless. So that, again, kind of sets the lineup. And all the way through, with those guys being your scratches out there, there's also no changes in the lineup for the Thunderbirds. They also have to run what they brung, if you will. And they will have no changes out there this evening. And so, same thing as last night. I imagine things getting testy towards the end of regulation. We might see it boil over just a little bit once again. Not entirely sure that that's going to happen, and I'm not going to guarantee you anything, River Dragons fans, but I feel like that might be one of the things we're going to come across tonight. What was interesting about last night, as testy as it got, it never turned into a parade to the penalty box. Both teams were fairly disciplined. In fact, there was only one power play for each side throughout the 60 minutes of regulation. Now, the River Dragons did earn a call in the overtime. They did fail to score on that. But they finish 0 for 2. And the Thunderbirds 0 for 1 on the power play. So these two teams, while they did play a hard physical game and they did go back and forth at one another, they didn't take penalties. And both of these teams are so good on special teams. River Dragons remain ranked first in the league on a penalty kill. And the Thunderbirds are third in both power play and penalty kill. The River Dragons power play, by the way, they've had so few chances this year that just by going 0 for 2, they dropped from second to fourth in the league. Also tells you how tight the top of that statistical category is. But again, I mean, we're talking top five special teams on both sides of the puck. That means a lot of talent, but it also means a lot of hard work and a good work ethic for both of these teams. And that played out in last night's game, and I expect more of the same here this evening. We're going to take another break in our Air Force Heating and Air pregame show. When we come back, it's time for that Zelmo's Zip-In Out-of-Town scoreboard, as there is a decent amount of action going on here on Friday or Saturday, November 25th, and we'll catch up to date on everything that is going on in and around the FPHL and the NHL as well, so stay tuned. And, I don't know if we're going to sneak in the college football scores from today or not. We might not be able to do that pregame, perhaps during one of the intermissions, but we'll nonetheless keep you up to date on what's going on in the hockey world. All right, stand by. More coming your way here in just a moment. This is Columbus River Dragons Hockey.
An injury can be a game changer. That's why Houston Sports Medicine Team provides urgent ortho care, Saturday morning injury clinics during hockey season, and an emergency room at Jack Houston Memorial Hospital. An injury can be a game changer, and immediate evaluation and care can be a game changer too. For more information, go to Houston.com or call 706-324-6661.
Hey sports fans, it's game time. There's no better time to make sure your heating and air system is working like it should. Air Force Heating and Air, the official AC sponsor of the Columbus River Dragons, is excited to offer you our special $79 tune-up. Call us today at 706-661-7242 or visit us at airforceheatingandair.com. That's airforceheatingandair.com. We're always here when you need us. Air Force Heating and Air. License number PC0004272, EC0101216.
The Jersey Shop specializes in screen printing, embroidery, direct-to-garment printing, and vinyl heat-press lettering and numbering. We provide custom T-shirts for any occasion and have a graphic designer on staff to make the logos or graphics needed to make your shirts unique. We pride ourselves on being able to deliver orders of any size at low, competitive cost with no minimum quantity. That's why the River Dragons trust the Jersey Shop for all of their uniform needs. Call 706-565-4245. That's 565-4245.
Hey, I'm Jackie, and a little thing I love about the Chick-fil-A chicken biscuit is the chicken. It is golden brown, so juicy, so delicious. It's the perfect savory start to my day.
Hey, I'm Matt, and a little thing I love about the Chick-fil-A chicken biscuit is the freshly baked, flaky, buttery biscuit. When I take a bite, it's kind of like, you know, crispy, soft, crispy. Crispy outside, soft interior, crispy chicken. There's really nothing like it.
Order a Chick-fil-A chicken biscuit and Simply Orange Juice on the Chick-fil-A app. Real guests paid for their testimonials.
And welcome back here on the Air Force Heating and Air pregame show. Tom Callahan here, my executive producer Drew Pierce along for the ride. Whether he likes it or not, he's got to work with me once again here. He keeps coming back, so I mean, it can't be all that bad. So anyway, we are getting ready to go here from the Winston-Salem Fairgrounds Annex. And looking forward to another doozy here tonight. Boy, I tell you what, the anticipation is definitely here. Good crowd already filing in here, and I would expect nothing less. The Thunderbirds fans love to support their team almost as much as they love to boo the Columbus River Dragons. But that's all right. We have thick skin. We could take it, and that's what being a rival is all about. Okay, let's take a look at that Zelmo Zip-In out-of-town scoreboard here. Let's see what's going on in the FPHL tonight. A grand total of 5 games, and we are one of them. We'll be the earliest one actually getting underway. Here's a little oddball for you. So we are 6:05 Eastern. Motor City in Elmira is 6:07 Eastern. Just to throw a little bit of a wrench in it, they're going to start just that 2 minutes later than this game here. 7 o'clock Eastern time, you've got the Danbury Hattricks at the Binghamton Black Bears. And then 6:05 Central, 7:05 Eastern, Port Huron Prowlers at the Mississippi Seawolves. And 7 o'clock Central, 8 o'clock Eastern time, you've got the Blue Ridge Bobcats at the Baton Rouge Idaho. So any fans from any of those other teams might be checking out the early action here tonight. We appreciate you being here. Thank you so much. As we're not quite underway yet, we're probably just a little bit, roughly 15 minutes from the drop of the puck, maybe a smidge more. Let's take a look at the NHL out-of-town scoreboard for you. One final to tell you about from earlier today. How about the New York Rangers drop a 7 spot on the Boston Bruins? 7-4 the final in that one. There is one game going on right now. The LA Kings up 2-0 on the Montreal Canadiens. And if you're a hockey fan from way back, you might remember the 1993 Stanley Cup final between those two teams. Here's, okay, a couple tidbits for you. Number one, that was Gretzky back in the Cup, but appearing for the first time with the LA Kings. Barry Melrose was coaching that team. There was an awful lot going on in that series, but it's also the last time a Canadian team won the Stanley Cup. Was 1993. And until that point, once the Canadians won the Cup in the 93 series, they had won a Cup in every decade since the NHL's inception, dating all the way back to the 19-teens. So how about that one? One more little tidbit while we're on it. Well, follow how all these branches connect. In the 19-teens, 1917 to be specific, the first U.S.-based team to win the Stanley Cup won it. That was the Seattle Metropolitans. The Seattle Kraken will be playing the Vegas Golden Knights in the Winter Classic. They unveiled their jerseys this week, and if you take a look at that Seattle jersey, it is a direct tribute to that first Seattle Stanley Cup championship team. Interestingly enough. Also, Seattle did make the Stanley Cup final in 1919, but it was canceled due to the flu pandemic that was going around. And so they played 5 games of the series, canceled the rest of the series, never awarded the cup. Okay, so all that came from telling you that the Kings are leading 2-0 over the Canadiens. That one's through 2 periods of play. 7 o'clock tonight, you got the Sabres and the Devils. These are all Eastern times. Leafs at Penguins. Then you've got Flyers at Islanders at 7:30. Flames of the Avalanche at 10 o'clock Eastern. Canucks at the Sharks and the Coyotes at the Golden Knights to round out the West Coast offerings. So how about the Coyotes? 8-9-2, putting together a pretty solid start for themselves. Lawson Crouse has absolutely caught fire lately. And I tell you what, this Coyotes team, I think a lot of teams are guilty of underestimating the Coyotes when they go in and face them. Now, I'm not saying the Golden Knights will do that, but that's how Arizona's going to jump up and beat you. They're still a talented team. Look, if you're in the NHL, you're a pretty darn good hockey player. So, yes, there are some teams that are better than others, and I'm looking at the Sharks at 3-15-2. But they're playing a surprise Canucks team at 14-6-1. Like, there's a lot of arguments you can make either way. Teams stocked with talent aren't always going to be the best teams. Everybody's scratching their head over what's going on with the Flames as well. They're a game under 500. So just so many storylines in this year's NHL, an awful lot for us to talk about. All right, before we get to the interview with head coach Jerome Boom Boom Bichard, I'll give you some college football scores. And if you haven't heard, the number 2 Ohio State, number 3 Michigan matchup today went to Michigan, 30-24 over Ohio State. Kentucky beat Louisville 38-31. Number 14 LSU won over Texas A&M 42-30. And games going on right now. Number 15 ranked Arizona 51-7 now in the third quarter over Arizona State. Wow, look at the Wildcats go. Number 8 Alabama is leading Auburn in the Iron Bowl 20-14. That is in the third quarter. BYU 24-13 over number 20 Oklahoma State. Potential upset in the making. Number 21 Tennessee has a 31-10 lead over Vanderbilt in the third. Liberty ranked 25th. 35-7 over UTEP in the third. And at the half, Washington State and number 4 Washington are tied at 14. All right, that's it for that Zelmo Zipping Out of Town scoreboard. We'll take a break, and when we come back, we will have a chat with Boom Boom Bichard, the head coach of your Columbus River Dragons. And then we're getting closer to dropping the puck here at the Winston-Salem Fairgrounds Annex. River Dragons and Thunderbirds coming up just a little past the top of the hour. This is the Air Force Heating and Air pregame show on Columbus River Dragons Hockey.
Let Shred Away, a division of the Overby Company, take care of all your document shredding needs. We can design a custom shredding program for your business today. No need to purchase equipment, no maintenance expenses, no need to prepare records for destruction, increase employee productivity, increase security, no worry. Was it really destroyed? Right now, all new customers can receive 10% off. Shred Away, a division of the Overby Company, locally owned and operated in downtown Columbus. That's Shred Away, 706-577-9668.
It's the fifth anniversary season of Columbus River Dragons hockey, and RiverDragonsMerch.com has everything you need, including our new limited edition anniversary look. RDragonsMerch.com has something for all ages, with a variety of hats, shirts, jackets, and more. Plus, cool souvenir items like the always popular fan chains, pucks, and keychains. Want to order a gift for someone? We'll ship it for you. Just go online to RDragonsMerch.com. Hey, sports fans, it's game time. There's no better time to make sure your heating and air system is working like it should. Air Force Heating and Air, the official AC sponsor of the Columbus River Dragons, is excited to offer you our special $79 tune-up. Call us today at 706-661-7242 or visit us at airforceheatingandair.com. That's airforceheatingandair.com. We're always here when you need us. Air Force Heating and Air. License number PC000-4272, EC0101216.
Is that the sound of an ooey gooey cheesy crunchy slice of PIZZA? Obviously. But as good as that sounds, we think it can get even better. Oh yeah, that's the sound of a freshly opened fizz-filled Pepsi. The only thing that can take this flavor medley of crunchy dough, mouth-watering cheese, and savory sauce to the next level. How about another bite? Pepsi and pizza sound like a match made in heaven and taste even better. Pizza, better with Pepsi. That's what I like.
Welcome back here in the Air Force Heating and Air pregame show. We're joined by River Dragons head coach Jerome Bichard. Coach, coming into tonight, the second half of a back-to-back. You're on the road in Carolina tonight. Talk to us about yesterday's shootout loss to the Thunderbirds.
Yeah, you know what? It's a little bit of a heartbreaker. But to be honest with you, after watching the game again, I thought we played pretty well. I saw two teams playing fairly tentatively, not want to give anybody anything, and I think both teams somewhat accomplished that, and you had a 2-1 hockey game where I don't think our fans are used to those 2-1 overtime wins or losses.
You see a tight game like that, so you talk about not wanting to give anything up, not wanting to be the team that makes a mistake, really. But is that typical, you think, for the first game of the series this season?
Yeah, I think so. I mean, I thought we played well. I thought we executed a few things. They got a couple of really good scoring chances. Colts played stopped them, and then their goalie played well as well. And I think we can execute a little bit more on the offensive side by doing a couple different things.
Well, and I guess that's really what the interest is for the fans, for everybody at home wondering, okay, so how do you just get that one extra goal tonight?
I think even though I think we outshot those guys yesterday, I think we can do a little bit more of a spread them out. They're kind of a swarm defense. They always have two, three, four guys around the puck, and I think if we can separate them a little bit and get some shots, and not so much particularly shooting the score, but maybe shots for rebounds and you know, kind of catch them not looking.
That was the other thing I thought yesterday watching them. They also have a pretty aggressive forecheck at times. They bring a lot of heat.
Well, you know what? They're fairly selective. They kind of lull you to sleep. All of a sudden, they're not coming, and then all of a sudden they take three hard strides and they're right on you type thing. So they kind of disguise her a little bit. They kind of their body motion is, you know, kind of slow, lackadaisical, and then all of a sudden they take three, four hard strides and they're right on you. So again, we got to be prepared. And last week, I think we kind of worked on a sense of urgency all over the ice. You know, just because we have time. Let's not take time, you know, just because it looks like they're not coming very hard, let's get back to the puck as fast as we possibly can, turn around, and then figure out what we're doing, as opposed to taking your time and lackadaisical, and then all of a sudden they're there, and you know, we gave them that opportunity as opposed to not having that sense of urgency.
Well, let's wrap it all up with the keys to the game.
Keys to the game on the road, you know what, I mean, obviously, I think they got maybe a little momentum with that win last night. So we got to have a short memory, get the puck in, get our legs going, get off the bus, get some energy, get some play physical, and, you know, put more in that than they did.
Boomer, thanks. Best of luck tonight.
You bet. Thanks.
Back with the drop of the puck in just a moment. This is Columbus River Dragons hockey.
It's a weekend to celebrate with the Columbus River Dragons. On Friday, December 8th, help celebrate the birthdays of Scorch and Torch with a festive mascot birthday featuring all your local favorites. Then on Saturday, December 9th, the River Dragons mark the team's fifth anniversary with the home debut of the club's special teal jerseys and a night of family fun. Tickets are on sale now through the Civic Center box office and online at Ticketmaster.com. River Dragons hockey, it's go time. It's a weekend to celebrate with the Columbus River Dragons. On Friday, December 8th, help celebrate the birthdays of Scorch and Torch with a festive mascot birthday featuring all your local favorites. Then on Saturday...
Cheer for our favorite teams together. We are closer to what counts. Beam has been improving the way we connect since 1964. Not just with technology, but with our communities and with each other. Because at Beam, community is not just a place. It's the way we do business. Beam. Bringing East Alabama more. It's in our name.
Hey, I'm Jackie, and a little thing I love about the Chick-fil-A chicken biscuit is the chicken. It is golden brown, so juicy, so delicious. It's the perfect savory start to my day.
Hey, I'm Matt, and a little thing I love about the Chick-fil-A chicken biscuit is the freshly baked, flaky, buttery biscuit. When I take a bite, it's kind of like, you know, crispy, soft, crispy. Crispy outside, soft interior, crispy chicken. There's really nothing like it.
Order a Chick-fil-A chicken biscuit and Simply Orange Juice on the Chick-fil-A app. Real guests paid for their testimonials.
It's time to drop the puck. Columbus River Dragons hockey is brought to you in part by Chick-fil-A Midland, Buffalo Rock Pepsi, Tim Hortons, Columbus Diagnostic, Shredaway, The Overby Company, Vector Ply, Trivioli's, The Jersey Shop, Beam TV, WIBU Christian Television Network, Troy University, Largeman Dental, BKI Accounting, The Optical Shop, Piggly Wiggly, Sun South John Deere, Wade Cleaners, Houston Clinic, Abercrombie Bonding, First Franklin Financial, and Old School Barbershop. Now it's time for the Chick-fil-A Midland first period. Here's Tom Callahan.
And welcome in, everybody. We are getting ready to go here tonight between the Columbus River Dragons and the Carolina Thunderbirds. Looks like the inflatable just going up down to our left. Then we'll have our anthem, our team introductions, and we'll get ready to drop the puck here in just a little bit. So looking forward to that. And so that should be coming up in just a little bit. In the meantime, let's take a look at the head-to-head comparison between these two teams. We told you how similar they are. in that Air Force Heating and Air pregame show. And for the River Dragons, coming into tonight at 7-1-1, 22 points on the year. And really what grabs you, again, it's the special teams numbers. Carolina 5-2-2, and they have a little bit of a gap points-wise, but the skill gap is right there. These two teams are very close. You see the River Dragons, I told you their power play fell from second to fourth, even though they only went 0-2 the other night. That's kind of how tight the standings are for that. But also, again, the River Dragons, a team that hasn't drawn a lot of power plays this year, again last night ended up with two, one in regulation, one in the overtime. They are still first in the penalty kill because Carolina went 0-1 on the power play. And the Thunderbirds, again, their power play and penalty kill. Everybody here, we're talking top, we're not only top five, but really top four in the league in both categories. These two teams have really just, they've been such a match for each other, a mirror almost. Now, they go about things sometimes in different ways, but at the end of the day, what wins, in my opinion, in a lot of people's opinions, championships is defense, goaltending, hard work, talent, determination. Both teams have that in spades. And so you look at this Columbus River Dragons roster, probably deeper than it's ever been, and they're looking to make a huge charge. Carolina, you want to talk about unfinished business, we talk about how the River Dragons probably feel that way a little bit, but I can imagine that the Carolina Thunderbirds say we have unfinished business from last year because they had a stranglehold, or so it appeared, on the Commissioner's Cup last year, and then all of a sudden it was ripped away from them. They couldn't close out the deal, and that stings. That leaves a mark. And unfortunately for this Thunderbirds team, they were unable to close things out last year. Danbury came back and hoisted the trophy that they very much wanted. And so at the end of the day, they, meaning the Thunderbirds, come back with much of the core they had last year. Probably there's some anger in that dressing room over the way things finished. Certainly you let it use that feeling as a driver of where you want to go and how you want to get there. And I can't imagine that if I was ever in that situation as a player, as a coach, as a front office member, boy, you just so close. You want to get back there again. And it's a season-long mission. Both teams have started out very well this year, and both teams off to just an absolute great start. But the real problem is that they go head-to-head a lot. Over the course of a season, you only play 56 games in the FPHL. Every game matters so much. And here's the other thing. Maybe you're new to the FPHL, but it always bears repeating that the point system here is based on a 3-2-1. So you can conceivably go into a weekend 6 points behind an opponent, win both games in regulation, and come out of the weekend tied. You can make up ground fast with regulation wins in this league. But that's also why it's so important when teams push each other past overtime. Even that single point, I know it stings if you're a River Dragons fan to only get one last night, but that one is still important. To not lose in regulation is important. To win in regulation is even more important. It makes it close, it makes it competitive, and it also keeps a lot of teams in it, quite frankly. I mean, you look down beyond Columbus in first, Carolina in second, you've got Mississippi, 11 games in there, 5-4-1-1, 18 points. You know, they're right there. Port Huron, 3-4-1-1, 12 points. They've played 9 games as well. Blue Ridge still has only one regulation win, as does Baton Rouge in 11 games. Whitville has won 7-2. They have 7 points and 1-9-1 for Baton Rouge. But those teams, if they go on a little bit of a streak, a little bit of a heater, especially because it's early in the season. I know they've played a decent amount of hockey, and Baton Rouge has played a lot of home games and will play a lot of home games. You can't let those teams up off the mat. You can't let them come back at you. And the River Dragons, who are booed as they enter the ice here at the Annex, know that they have a very important task ahead of them tonight. And they're going to go ahead and try to do the absolute best they can to keep the Thunderbirds from picking up 3-2 or even a single point here tonight. Well, while we're waiting for the Thunderbirds starting lineup introductions here down on the ice, why don't we take a look at tonight's starting goaltenders? And for the Thunderbirds, it's going to be more of the same here tonight. Mario Cavallari right back in the crease for the Thunderbirds. He's carrying a 6-2 record on the year with a .930 save percentage, 2.09 goals against average. And then you've got Taylor Joseph going for the River Dragons, 2-0 in his only two appearances this year with a .935 save percentage and a 1.50 goals against average. And so Joseph is going to get the second half of the back-to-back here as Colgan played last night, played very well. It went down to a shootout. Unfortunately, it was the Thunderbirds that won in the shootout. But in regulation, Brendan Colgan, and in the overtime, actually in the overtime, Brendan Colgan didn't have to face a shot. That was also something that was interesting in last night's game. The Thunderbirds outshot by the River Dragons 6-0 in the OT. Again, Columbus had a power play, but that's pretty significant that the River Dragons didn't even allow a shot for the Thunderbirds in the 5 minutes of 3-on-3 OT. So again, take the positives where you can find them and know that it is a long season series, and there's a lot of hard minutes in those season series. Hopefully, again, Columbus here tonight gets out there, jumps on the Thunderbirds early, because right now, as this arena is starting to pack up, it's one of the smaller arenas in the league, but it is loud, and tonight it looks like it's going to be pretty jammed in here as they bring the Thunderbirds out on the ice. And it'll be on the River Dragons not to let the Thunderbirds impose their will here as the home team in front of the home crowd on a Saturday night and try to take the game to the River Dragons. Instead, it's on the River Dragons to take their game to the Thunderbirds. So they're going to introduce the starting lineups here for the Thunderbirds. We can tell you the starting lineups for the River Dragons tonight. Defensively, it's going to be the pair of Nolan Slahetka, who had the regulation goal for the River Dragons yesterday, along with Lane King. And then up front, it's going to be the big line of Justin McDonald, Cody Wickline, and Alexander Jemayev. That line, all three of them in double-digit points on the year. They are 1-2-3 in scoring on the River Dragons. As a matter of fact, only one other player has reached double-digit points. That's Austin Doe. The part correct, well, yes, Austin Doe, 10 points. A couple guys knocking on the doorstep of it. Kyle Moore, Alex Dorjahan there at 8 points on the season. Lane King has 9 assists to start the year. But the depth of scoring that we talk about for this River Dragons team, they're going to need to start to see a little more of that distributed through the lineup. Guys like Hunter Bersani, who got off to a decent start, had a 2-goal game earlier, but has been quiet a little bit as of late. There's going to be some pressure on him. You look at Sequoia Swan, scored in the first game, hasn't done a whole lot offensively since. Isn't playing every game, to be fair, but they will need him to step up a little bit more as well. Ryan Hunter, 2 assists, still waiting for his first goal on the season. And, you know, Alex Dorjahan's a guy I know they're going to be looking at. Again, without Josh Petrantonio in the lineup, it does have a little bit of a different tone to it for the guys playing here tonight. And if you're just joining us, Petrantonio is out tonight, along with Alex Basie. And Carson Andreoli remains on the IR, so we're getting ready to have the national anthem performed here before tonight's game and get things underway between the Carolina Thunderbirds and your Columbus River Dragons. Let's send it down to the ice.
Tonight by Eric Davidson.
Come and sing.
So getting ready to go before tonight's game, the River Dragons and the Thunderbirds. We'll get it going here in just a moment. All right, back to Spot the Jersey with Tom. Tonight's edition starts off with, again, another Clark Griswold sighting here. I did see a Charlie Conway jersey earlier. They're everywhere. But what I've never seen before, black jersey, yellow name and number, and a shamrock patch on the left shoulder. Says Murphy's 96. I can only assume that's a Dropkick Murphy's jersey. I have never seen that before, but that's pretty cool. All kinds of neat jerseys running around here, and of course, plenty of Thunderbirds jerseys, a lot of fans here. I do see some sprinkled, assorted River Dragons merch, and we know that River Dragons fans travel well and love to represent their team. We have a ceremonial puck drop coming up here, down on the carpet, and well, I thought we did. Jay Krupp went over to take the faceoff, and everybody walked off the ice. Maybe we won't. All right. Well, they got to chase him back out on the ice. Hey, come on back out here. Drop the puck. We need to get this game going. So our thanks to anyone stopping by to join us here, whether on YouTube or on our flagship station, 106.9 Really Rocks. Want to remind everybody, you've got a great chance coming up to meet the River Dragons in a couple of days. You can meet us at Chick-fil-A Midland on the 29th. From 5 to 7 p.m. And the River Dragons will be at the next Eat with the Dragons event at Applebee's on Airport Thruway Thursday, November 30th at 5 p.m. That's a great chance to meet the team, get pictures and autographs, and check out the new holiday combos starting at just $13.99 for a limited time. Okay. Looks like we have everything completed ceremonially. We're about ready to drop the puck on this one. And here we go. It's one back by Carolina. And the Thunderbirds will control it up the left side. They'll sweep it in from center. Thunderbirds wearing the black jerseys here tonight. As the River Dragons in the road, whites and an early shot by McDonald. Sticked away by Cavallari. Played around to the near corner to Jemayev, who tries to center. That one is knocked in behind by Ford. Jemayev over after it in the corner. Jemayev up to the point, moving over Slahetka through traffic. High shot just over the crossbar. McDonald fighting off a check. Leaves it down low to Wickline. Wickline feeds up to the left point. Slahetka looks into the slot. A backhand attempt coming up. Jemayev is stopped on the doorstep. Good save by Cavallari. Jemayev could have spun and tried to get to his forehand. Instead, he did get the shot off a little bit quicker. Might have been even tougher for the goaltender to make that save. Nice play by Lane King back in the defensive zone as he rides Dumas off the puck. River Dragons change it up. Here comes Jay Krupp moving it ahead with Bersani. He'll dump it right in. Cavallari holds. And we'll get a faceoff. Tonight's referee introductions are brought to you by the Optical Shop in Phoenix City, where right now $99 in a bag of chips gets you two pair of eyeglasses. Your referees tonight, Kenny Mons wearing number 55, and Richard Green number 37, linesman Patrick Callen number 27, and Chris Kwong number 31. Draw coming up to the left of the Thunderbirds cage. Puck down, River Dragons. Trying to control Doe, fighting for it. Popped it into the slot, but it was knocked away there by Felder. And ends up out at center. Thunderbirds chip it ahead, but stolen by Underwood. Ahead to Bersani, he tips it in. 1:20 gone here in this opening frame. River Dragons have come out and tried to push the pace. Turnover in the high slot. Bersani tried to get a shot off, had his stick lifted. At the line, Blackwell forced it through, and it just gets deflected at the last moment. Ends up in the corner. You're still on the right side, to the right point, Underwood. Quickly over to the left side. There's a shot, and that is blocked. Goes behind the net. Bersani on the backhand leaves it into the far side area of the slot, taken away by Salak. He'll put it up the wall. Thunderbirds looking to break ahead. And there's Panacek in with a chance, and he fanned on it. River Dragons recovering. Pastuca, last night's hero, couldn't get to the puck. Bockwell takes it away and gives it to Krupp, who's out the left side. Krupp slows up, gives it on the right side. Bounce pass for Shinkarik. He couldn't handle it. Bersani back after the puck. River Dragons need a change here. Gill is out. Flips it up the glass. Storjahan at least out there now. He ends up with it. Left wing and gets it over the blue line. Columbus is trying to get the forward unit shuffled around here. Storjahan with a bank pass ahead. Looking for Hunter. Turned away from him. Now back up the left side. In over the line. Here comes Nate Keeley. His shot wide of the net. Right side a turnaround chance. That goes off the outside of the goal there. Boutina let it go. Nate Keeley on the right side, puck into the slot. That shot is blocked. Krupp is still out there, has not been able to get to the bench. Long shift for Krupp. Ryan Hunter up the right side with it, moving in. Storjahan with him. Tried to get past the check there. Bione wrote him off on the wall. King back across to Slahetka. Right side, here's Moore. Moore in over the line, fakes, walks around the D. He's in to the forehand, ran out of room, tried to stuff it back on the near side, nowhere to go. Puck to the right point, King looks through a seam, lets it go, save Cavallari, rebound, Storjahan right back to King of the right point. Quickly over to the left side, Slahetka, wrist shot, wide of the net, right half wall, Moore. Moore, cross ice, wanted to get it, I think the Slahetka might have been deflected, out it goes. Columbus will regroup in its own end. Here's Moore. Flips it to an open wing. That forces Jemayev back after it. He leaves it there for Moore, who will just pitch it to center. River Dragons finishing up a change as McDonald dumps it back towards that Thunderbirds blue line. Ford wheeling in his own end with a little chip in the space on the right side. That one is dumped in on the left wing corner. Dumas after it. Slahetka had it played away around to the right point. Kept in by Kennedy. Kennedy in behind the net. McDonald ends up with the puck. We've had a lot of action and few whistles here. 4:10 into it. No score in the first. Wickline left side stops at the line. Waiting for help. Has to sweep it deep. Cavallari out trying to catch up with it. He's way out there. McDonald backhands it in front. And the defense bailing out the goaltender there as Cavallari was out for a walk. Back the other way come the Thunderbirds. Driving the left side is Salak trying to cut in on goal, and he had it taken away. Bockwell with a stick check. Turn back the center. Jemayev will just dump it on in. Cavallari makes a save on it. River Dragons go for the change. Thunderbirds trying to go back the other way, but it's turned over at center. Bockwell on the right side looking to bank it ahead. Too far for Doe. And Panacek waiting for the puck. Never got to him. Right back, here's Swan. Sequoia Swan with a wrist shot, hit a shin pad. Tried to fight his way through traffic. Might have taken a stick up high there, but play continues. Thunderbirds back up the left side now. Here's Salak on the right wing, and that could have been a penalty, and it is. Bockwell wraps up Peter Panacek pretty good. And so into the Abercrombie Bonding penalty box for Nate Bockwell. .509 time of the penalty. We'll take a break and come back with more in just a moment. This is Columbus River Dragons Hockey.
Hey, I'm Jackie, and a little thing I love about the Chick-fil-A chicken biscuit is the chicken. It is golden brown, so juicy, so delicious. It's the perfect savory start to my day.
Hey, I'm Matt, and a little thing I love about the Chick-fil-A chicken biscuit is the freshly baked, flaky, buttery biscuit. When I take a bite, it's kind of like, you know, crispy, soft, crispy. Crispy outside, soft interior, crispy chicken. There's really nothing like it.
Order a Chick-fil-A chicken biscuit and Simply Orange Juice on the Chick-fil-A app. Real guests paid for their testimonials.
Get ready to hoop it up this season in Trojan Arena with Troy Basketball. Combined season tickets for men's and women's basketball start at $75 for all 24 home games. You won't find a better deal than that. Get your Troy Basketball season tickets now at TroyTrojans.com/tickets. The action begins November 6th, and we want to see you all season long. Visit TroyTrojans.com/tickets and lock in your Troy Basketball season tickets now.
And we are back here at the Winston-Salem Fairgrounds Annex. Tom Callahan here with you. River Dragons taking on the Carolina Thunderbirds. And the River Dragons will be shorthanded here. Bach will into the box. 2 minutes for holding. Face-off will be to the left of Taylor Joseph in the River Dragons' end. Power play for the Thunderbirds. They come in right on 25%, second in the league. 89.3 on a kill. That's first for Columbus, and they will start with a clear on down the ice. So good start for the River Dragons. It's Moore and Storjahan up front. Gill and Shinkarik back on defense. Thunderbirds looking up the left side. Going ahead, here's Clay Keeley onto the right wing. Dumped in around the rim it goes. And it's cleared out. Nice job between Moore and Shinkarik to generate a clear there. Moore made the hit to separate the man, and Shinkarik sent it down. Now it'll be Doe and Hunter out. Gill and Shinkarik remain for the moment. 32 seconds into the power play, the Thunderbirds have yet to set up, and now they put the play back outside the line and are just struggling at this point to get the puck in deep. Ford's pass hit Shinkarik, came back to him. He'll try to wheel on the right side. He does get over the line. Cross ice feed, but that is tipped away by Doe into the corner. Gill jams it around the wall towards the point, not out. Pastuca has come out. Thunderbirds are trying to start a change on their power play unit here, but now they're established in the zone. Left up top, Pastuca over to the near dot. Baker will rotate it around. Cross ice feed to the far dot, and the slot is poked at and cleared out and down by Hunter. Nice job by Gill with the active stick there. River Dragons trying to change up. Now here's Pastuca's got room on the left side. In with a shot, and a blocker saved Joseph as he came way out for that one. And the puck is bounced out through center. Thunderbirds looking to turn it the other way. Butita with the lead on the right wing side. Panacek got it over the line looking for Salak. Turned over to King. King to the line, not out. And there's a shot by Butita. Save, rebound, went right past Schnapp, who was cruising the left side. Ends up at the left point. Pastuca will feed it over to the right point. Panacek out of the box is Bockwill. So the River Dragons do spring Bockwill out of that Abercrombie bonding penalty box. And 0 for 1 on the power play for the Thunderbirds. They keep the pressure, though. There's a wrist shot right into the breadbasket of Taylor Joseph. He holds it now. Schnapp getting plenty of attention in front of that River Dragons net. Now Butita's going to go in, start pushing and shoving with Bockwill. And it's going to get a little ornery. I don't know if we're going to get anything extra called out of it, but we'll see if they do or not. I think we're going to get something. Referees over talking right now at the scorer's table. There's nobody in the box, though. It's a little early to be handing out tens, I think. 7.5 minutes into this first period, shots are even at 4 apiece. No goals on the board yet for either side. Maybe just some finger waggling, and of course, Jerome Bichard right now is pretty animated over there on the River Dragons bench. He is pretty upset about something. It's 5-on-5 still. Face-off is going to be taken back outside the blue line. So no penalties handed out there. Just a lot of aggravation for players on both sides, I think. Krupp will move the puck ahead for the River Dragons, and there's a turnover at center. Pinball's back towards Doe. He'll feed it to the D's. Lahetka pass ahead. It's tipped away from Krupp, and actually Baker chips it in behind his own net. Back for it now. James Farmer. Pressure down to the near side. Bione back towards Farmer on the far wall. And the Thunderbirds try the breakout through center. Ford will fling it in from there. Joseph out to try to stop it. It skipped away from him. King fed it back in behind the net. Coughed up on the near side to Krupp. He'll lift the wedge out to center. Bersani trying to hustle after it. It reaches the Thunderbirds D first. And now they run into each other and turn the puck over. Krupp will leave it off right side. He'll get it back and chip it in. Storjahan is up there by himself on the forecheck. Arriving on the left wing is Hunter. Puck goes past him. And now the Thunderbirds look to leave the zone. They bring it ahead on the right side. Carolina in with a shot. That's deflected off the D. A little bit of slashing in behind the play between Bockwell and look like Gus Ford. Bockwell ends up with it at center. He'll dump it near corner. It dies there. Moore after it. On the bouncer, Moore wraps out the far side. Still looking for a place. Backdoor feed. Here's Hunter in. Cavallari down. He shot it over top of the net. Not a play. Boy, Hunter did a nice job just to corral that puck in the first place. It was in a difficult spot for him, but he's able to bring it down. Eventually let the shot go, but Cavallari's pretty quick laterally. Seeing him yesterday and today, he's very good at that left or right movement, and if it is a bit of a hesitation to get a shot off against him, he's going to recover and do a great job taking away net. Face off to the left of the Thunderbirds' goal. McDonald in for the draw. And tossed out of the draw is Panacek. Salak will come in instead. And now McDonald tossed out of the draw. All right, Wickline in. He wins it back. McDonald tips it to Underwood. Underwood sends it around the rim. Wickline chasing. Far side, tried to cycle it for Jamea if it was blocked. But it's kept in. Skipped towards the net. Cavallari will catch it and hold. 9:04 gone here in the first. No score between these two teams. And the River Dragons, I think, have carried a little bit more of the balance of play here, although they have given up a power play chance against in this first half of the first period, but they killed that off, as you would expect that top-ranked penalty kill to do. Fakes off is one back into the corner. River Dragons trying to tie it up over there. Puck around to the near side. Wickline cutting it off before it leaves the zone. McDonald pressured, gets it onto the right wing rim. Jamath backhands it around. Wickline far corner, sends it towards the front of the net, and Cavallari is able to flop the mitt on that one and cover. And he holds on. First period brought to you by Chick-fil-A Midland here and River Dragons Hockey all season long. We want to say thank you to our partners and ask you to please support those who support us. If you're thinking about heading out somewhere, going out, grabbing whether it's dinner or filling up your gas tank, we just ask you to help us out, support those who support us. Point blank chance right there. Storjahan is denied on the doorstep. Now Hunter again, Storjahan, and that one sent wide to the far post. Here's Moore keeping it in. Hunter cycling on the left side. Hunter, high slot, flips it. Right point, Shinkarik will shoot, and that one rolls wide. Storjahan sending it around. Here's Moore in the right side corner. Tried to set it up top. That one kind of hopped on him. It allows Thunderbirds to clear to center, but Shinkarik looking to turn it back. Cannot. It's dumped in. Joseph cannot catch up with it. It's a decent amount of room behind the net here in Carolina. It looks like more than normal by a foot or two back there, so it takes the goaltenders a little bit longer to get back there to a puck. Chip down to center. Thunderbirds recover. And they'll push it back in on the left wing side. Nate Keeley trying to get after it. One of two Keeley twins playing for this Thunderbirds team this year. Bounce pass ahead here. Swan lost it in his skates. Turning with it is Firth. And now right back the other way. Firth to the line to Butina. Back onto the right side. A shot and a blocker save there by Joseph. Firth keeping it in. Puck sent towards the point. A bouncer that gets out. Thunderbirds will regroup. River Dragons working on a change in the meantime. Joseph will catch that dump and leave it for Gill. Gill sets up behind his own net. G- Gill looks out the left side, on to the right wing now. Here's Bersani. Pass into space, and Carrick hustling to catch up with it. Tried to pop it past the D, but Firth took it away. Cleared back out. Bersani on the backhand, tossing it back in. River Dragons changing the D while Felder recovers. Feeds it behind his own net. Firth, pressure by Bersani, turned it over. Centering feed by Swan. Doe couldn't come down with the puck as it popped up in the air, but it's kept in left side. Swan. Swan in front. There was nobody there in the low slot for that puck. Great feed by Swan. Back the other way. Here come the Thunderbirds. King on Dumas as he goes to the corner. And now we got a penalty coming up in behind the play. Hunter Bersani arguing here, but a hit in behind the play, and I'm not sure who it was. But we'll step aside for a break. When we come back, we'll tell you about it. So stay tuned. We're coming your way scoreless with 8:21 to go in the first, and it's already turning into a bit of a fracas out here. Actually, we're going to stay here for a minute because now Sequoia Swan and Ford are kind of taking jabs at one another. And they're going to take one from each side. All right, now we're going to head to the break. We'll be back with more in just a moment. This is River Dragons Hockey.
Hey, I'm Jackie, and a little thing I love about the Chick-fil-A chicken biscuit is the chicken. It is golden brown, so juicy, so delicious. It's the perfect savory start to my day.
Hey, I'm Matt, and a little thing I love about the Chick-fil-A chicken biscuit is the freshly baked, flaky, buttery biscuit. When I take a bite, it's kind of like, you know, crispy, soft, crispy. Crispy outside, soft interior, crispy chicken. There's really nothing like it.
Order a Chick-fil-A chicken biscuit and Simply Orange Juice on the Chick-fil-A app. Real guests paid for their testimonials.
In 1999, Watley Convenience Stores opened its first Zelmo's Zip Inn. Since then, the brand has grown to include 11 stores in the Chattahoochee Valley and Southwest Georgia. Zelmo's is an anchor in the communities it operates in. Our managers, employees, and vendors are all an integral part of the neighborhoods and communities we serve. We're proud to call these areas home and plan to continue growing with and serving the communities of West Georgia and East Alabama. Zelmo's, fueling life's passions.
Well, we're still sorting it out. Ford is complaining to the referee, and they're going to open the door. Ford has a lot to say here. Bersani is in the box as well. And there's nothing up on the board right now on either side, so it looks like they may be coincidentals here, but they haven't posted the penalties yet, so I don't know that for sure, but... Well, now there's an extra two. Oh, no, it's two, and then Bersani gets five. Bersani gets a five-minute major. So that means it's going to be four on four for two solid minutes here. And then the River Dragons have 3 minutes of a five-minute major power play to kill off. Oh, boy. Let's see what they do with the four-on-four in the meantime. Here's Underwood driving on the left side. Puck to the point. Bachwell will send it around, roughing the call against Ford. So Bersani got five for slashing. And there's a chance for the Thunderbirds, blocked on that far side. Bachwell up with it, and his lead pass to center, unfortunately, was behind both McDonald and Wickline. Otherwise, could have been a two-on-one there, but the Thunderbirds break back in. Salak lost it off his skates, battling to get it back, jousting with McDonald. Puck on the boards. Underwood ran into a pile that now includes Panacek. Bachwell over to try to help him out. Forced up to the left point. Pastuca holding it in. Panacek moving it across up top. Kennedy will elect to go back out to center with it. 49 seconds left to go in the four-on-four situation, and then the Thunderbirds end up with that major power play. Back after it, Slahetka on a rolling puck. He'll bank it around to Underwood. Underwood feels the pressure coming at him, sidesteps it, banks it back to Slahetka, takes the hit. Puck ahead to center. And the Thunderbirds Starting to feel it a little bit. All of a sudden, they're playing a little bigger. Time ticking down to the four-on-four situation here. Still scoreless in this first period. In over the line. Storjahan trying to steal it back. He does. And now the River Dragons break. Maybe a chance here. Here's King up the right wing. Has help. King with a shot. And Cavallari folds down on it. Has it in the gear, and he hangs on. 3 seconds left to go in this four-on-four. And Schnapp drawing the attention of many white jerseys out there. Then 3 minutes of a major power play. So on a major power play, if you happen to score, you stay on the power play. And the River Dragons, again, number one in the penalty kill. You certainly don't want to keep giving chances to a team like the Thunderbirds, but well, the River Dragons, no shortage of work ethic here. As King is shading back towards the line a little bit here with 3 seconds to go because Ford's stepping out of the box. Puck is kept in by Columbus, and Carolina will regroup, and they are now on the power play. And here come the Thunderbirds on the right side. They try to walk it in. Ford wheels on the right wing, feeds up to the right point to Kennedy. Right half wall is Clay Keeley to Ford. Cross ice feed tipped away just before it got to Baker. Then he took a swat at Storjahan, but he cleared it anyway. Clay Keeley back the other way. Up to the left point, Baker. Ford on the left half wall. Right point Kennedy to the dot. Baker into the slot. Taken away there. Nice job by Moore sticking the lane, and out goes the puck. 2 minutes left to go on the major power play. We have 5:18 to go in the first. Scoreless between Carolina and Columbus. And, ooh, a puck mishandled right in front of the net, but Panoncic recovered. Thunderbirds will go back the other way through center now. Ford skates it in, tries to leave it into space, ends up at the line, and now under the right half wall. Here's Baker up top with it. He'll get it down low. Ford, backdoor feed, the shot, and they score. A cross ice pad as Ford finds Panoncic. Joseph couldn't get over in time. He got a piece of it, just didn't get all of it. And it's a power play goal for the Thunderbirds. They lead it 1-0. The Thunderbirds will now stay on the power play with a minute 32 seconds of power play time. Time of the goal, 15:07. That's going to get us to a timeout here. Or at least it should, but they're going to drop the puck here. So the power play continues. I thought we were going to go to immediate timeout. Thunderbirds on the regroup here. It stays 5-on-4. And they will bring it ahead on the left side. Here's Salak in over the line. Salak tied up on the board. Swan took a run at him. Boy, a real battle here on this near side. Four players in that pile. Puck to the left point, held in by Pastuca. Over to the right side, Panoncic. Up top, Pastuca. His pass over to the near side, tipped Salak. To the point, Pastuca, right side, Panoncic, half wall. Looking up top with it, Panoncic, dancing on the far wall. To the dot, tried to slide it up top. Jamea popped it up in the air. Salak in the left half boards with it now as the Thunderbirds keep it in. There's a chance at front, and Joseph a save on the doorstep as Schnapp got a tip to it. There's a chance at front again. That goes off the outside of the net. Salak in behind the goal, trying to play it around off of Jemayev. He'll get it to the near point. Pastuca over to the far side. Panoncic top of the far circle. Tried to feed it across, turned over, but River Dragons couldn't clear. Butita in the corner. Schnapp feeding it up top, cross ice. Here's Salak, fanned on it at the dot. Out of the box is Bersani as the puck comes out. So the River Dragons give up a power play goal on that five-minute slashing call. And it's 1-0. Carolina in the lead. 3 minutes to go here in this first period. Here's Jay Krupp up the left side in, looking for Dole, cutting in front. He's hooked up. Penalty coming up against the Thunderbirds. So we'll take a break, and when we come back, the River Dragons head on to the power play. Stay tuned. There's more coming your way in just a moment. This is Columbus River Dragons Hockey.
Hey, I'm Jackie, and a little thing I love about the Chick-fil-A chicken biscuit is the chicken. It is golden brown, so juicy, so delicious. It's the perfect savory start to my day.
Hey, I'm Matt, and a little thing I love about the Chick-fil-A chicken biscuit is the freshly baked, flaky, buttery biscuit. When I take a bite, it's kind of like, you know, crispy, soft, crispy. Crispy outside, soft interior, crispy chicken. There's really nothing like it.
Order a Chick-fil-A chicken biscuit and Simply Orange Juice on the Chick-fil-A app. Real guests paid for their testimonials.
For Beam, community isn't just a place, it's a state of mind. We believe that when we care together, work together, and even cheer for our favorite teams together, we are closer to what counts. Beam has been improving the way we connect since 1964. Not just with technology, but with our communities and with each other. Because at Beam, community is not just a place, it's the way we do business. Beam, bringing East Alabama more. It's in our name.
Back here at the Annex, Winston-Salem Fairgrounds. Tom Callahan here with you. Another great night of FPHL hockey. Columbus River Dragons now heading on to the Loft power play, hooking the call against Felder. The Loft features live music every Friday and Saturday night. Show your River Dragons ticket stub for 2-for-1 deal on cover. Thunderbirds with a 1-0 lead. 2:54 left to go here in the period. And so the River Dragons to the power play. There's a shot tipped into the netting. Faceoff will stay inside. Columbus will start with Underwood and Bockwell on the points here. Bersani, Doe, and Krupp up front on this power play. Nolan Slahetka will join us in our first period intermission. Brought to you by SunSouth John Deere. Stick around for that coming up in just a little bit. Bersani in for the faceoff, gets it over to Krupp. He kicks it back to the point. Underwood, left side, Bockwell. Bockwell, pass somehow eludes Bersani. Doe has to sweep it around to the right point to Underwood. Quickly back over to Bockwell. Bockwell, his wrister, blocker, save Cavallari. It's his first action in a little while. Tied up in the far side corner. Bersani out of the pile with it. Up top, Doe to the right side. Underwood looking for a seam. Shot is blocked by Schnapp. Tried to hook it out of there. Kept in. Krupp. And now it ends up with Bockwell all the way over in the right wing corner as he comes over to help out. Bockwell up to the right point. Underwood looking. Feeds to the right half boards. Here's Doe. Doe. Bockwell back to Underwood. Underwood to Doe. Tried to kick it towards the front of the net. Ends up on the far side, Bersani to the left point, Bockwell. Bockwell to the right point, here's Underwood. Underwood fakes a shot, now he lets it go, and just getting a piece with the blocker was Cavallari. Falling on the far side, looking for some help. Let go, Bersani, let it go to the point. Shot coming in, that one is stopped. Underwood scooting off the ice here as it's cleared down. Joseph handles the bouncer. 43 seconds to go in the Loft power play. Minute and a half to go in the period. 1-0 Thunderbirds. River Dragons on the attack. Here comes Shinkarik. Shinkarik busting in by himself, driving in from the lane, and he was just tripped up at the last moment. Gill to the right point with it. Feeds it over to the left side. Here's McDonald. McDonald with a wrist shot. Blocker save. He'll keep it down low. Chipped it actually past Wickline around the glass. No, it took a weird kick off the corner. Went right back behind the net. And this time the Thunderbirds able to get it down. Shinkarik back for the puck. On to the right side for Wickline. Wickline tried to feed it across, and it's turned back down by Butita. Under a minute to go here in the first. And now the power play comes to a close. McDonald back in, feeding Wickline on the right side. Wickline tried to put it in front, ends up tipped behind the net. And out. Here's Salak. Right side at center, wheels it in. Left wing, Panacek. Panacek, top of the dot, his shot fought off by the blocker there of Taylor Joseph, and out of play. Draw will stay in the River Dragons end. 32.3 seconds left to go in the first. Tied up on the dot. Cleared off the glass, not out. King stepping over for it. Now back the other way to Hunter. Hunter on the right wing side, chasing it behind the net. Boy, Cavallari coming way out to play that one. Backhands it along to the line. It does get to center. That pass hit Moore in the back. He didn't see it. Puck is back out over the line. Thunderbirds must tag up. They dump it back in, right to Slahetka. Moore, and that'll do it. They'll run the clock out. So the opening 20 comes to a close here in Winston-Salem, and the Thunderbirds skating off with a 1-0 lead thanks to a power play goal. And it is a testy game so far. I don't think it's going to get any less so here in this one. So should be exciting, entertaining hockey, as it always is when these two teams go head-to-head. And we're going to step into our first period intermission report, which is brought to you by SunSouth John Deere. And that first period intermission will contain a look back at the scoring and the stats from this opening frame, plus a Zelmo Zippin out-of-town scoreboard. But before we get to all of that, we've got our chat with Nolan Slahetka coming up. So stay tuned. That's on the other side of the break. 1-0 Thunderbirds after one period of play. This is Columbus River Dragons Hockey.
It's year-end sales event time at SunSouth. Get exceptional offers on quality John Deere equipment, including available 0% financing.
Welcome back to the SunSouth John Deere First Period Intermission Report. We're joined by Nolan Slahetka. And Nolan, I wanted to have you on, first of all, to ask you about that big goal last night. Slap shot in the third, breaks the deadlock, and gets the River Dragons on the board. Take us through that play.
Yeah, it's kind of a back-and-forth game all night, so it was finally nice to see puck go in. But no, just kind of drove one of our plays that we've been practicing in practice, and it was executed perfectly, and Wicks made a nice pass just right in my wheelhouse, and luckily I found one of their sticks and deflected right in. So yeah, it was a good feeling to have once no pucks were really going in, so it was nice to see one going.
Do you kind of get the feeling when you get that far into a game that it's going to take a break or a bounce to actually get something going?
Oh yeah, we were kind of saying it all night. We were just saying it's not going to be pretty. It's gonna come off a shin pad, a stick, or something like that. So and of course that's what it did. So yeah, fortunate enough, it was off my stick. So yeah, I have to get the one goal lead at that time.
There you go. And then unfortunately, you do end up the game tied late. Then you lose in the shootout. So coming into today's game, I mean, what's the talk about? Hey, how are we going to turn this around? What do we need to do to take that extra step?
Yeah, no, we know we're a good team, and we know good teams don't lose two nights in a row, so that's a big motto for us. And we're gonna try and just keep getting shots like we did last night, and hopefully more of them go in than they did last night. So
restorative work, cosmetics, prosthetics, and Invisalign braces too. Dr. Largeman has over 19 years of clinical experiences in all phases of dentistry and holds memberships in 4 different esteemed dental societies. Set your next appointment by calling 706-322-6581 or visit them online at largemandental.com.
Columbus, Georgia is considered by some as the hockey town of the South, boasting pro hockey since 1996. But 80 years before that first puck drop, another Chattahoochee Valley favorite got its start, Piggly Wiggly. Come on down to find a great selection of fresh meats and produce for your family's next meal or your next tailgate. We're proud to root for the hometown River Dragons because we've been the hometown team since forever. Piggly Wiggly, down home, down the street.
Phoenix Eye Clinic, located inside the optical shop in Phoenix City, wants to be your local eye doctor. Specializing in diabetic eye exams, glaucoma treatment, and cataract evaluations, Phoenix Eye Clinic has an ophthalmologist on staff. They also handle all of your needs for eye exams, glasses, and contacts. Call the Phoenix Eye Clinic at 334-480-4015. That's 334-480-4015. Phoenix Eye Clinic, located inside the optical shop.
yeah, hopefully we just keep peppering them with shots and just get a more puck luck tonight. So
I know heading out on the road for the second half, sometimes, I mean, depending on how you look at it, and coach says, well, hey, both teams got to travel coming into this game, right? So you're kind of on equal footing.
Yeah, no, it is always tough doing a home and home, but it's just part of the game, and it's nice time to get to spend with the guys, of course. Rather than that, yeah, they just gotta figure out, get your legs under you early on, and just hopefully they stick with you the whole game.
All right, Nolan, thanks for joining us. Appreciate the time.
Yeah, thank you for having me.
Back with more of the first period intermission in just a moment. This is River Dragons Hockey. Welcome back to the Sun South John Deere first period intermission report. We're joined by Nolan Slahetka. And Nolan, I wanted to have you on first of all to ask you about that big goal last night. Slap shot in the third, breaks the deadlock, and gets the River Dragons on the board. Take us through that play.
Yeah, it was kind of a back and forth game all night. So it was finally nice to see a puck go in. But no, we just kind of drew up one of our plays that we've been practicing in practice, and it was executed perfectly. And Wicks made a nice pass just right in my wheelhouse. And luckily, I found one of their sticks and deflected right in. So, yeah, it was a good feeling to have once no pucks were really going in. So it was nice to see one going.
Do you kind of get the feeling when you get that far into a game that it's going to take a break or a bounce to actually get something going?
Oh, yeah. We were kind of saying it all night. We were just saying it's not going to be pretty. It's gonna come off a shin pad or stick or something like that. So, and of course, that's what it did. So, yeah, fortunate enough, it was off my stick. So, yeah, I have to get the one goal lead at that time.
There you go. And then, unfortunately, you do end up the game tied late, then you lose in the shootout. So coming into today's game, I mean, what's the talk about, hey, how are we going to turn this around? What do we need to do to take that extra step?
Yeah, no, we know we're a good team, and we know good teams don't lose two nights in a row. So that's a big motto for us. And, yeah, no, we're going to try and just keep getting shots like we did last night, and hopefully more of them go in than they did last night. So, yeah, hopefully we just keep peppering them with shots and just get a more puck luck tonight. So
I know heading out on the road for the second half, sometimes, I mean, depending on how you look at it, and coach says, well, hey, both teams got to travel coming into this game, right? So you're kind of on equal footing.
Yeah, no, it is always tough doing a home and home, but it's just part of the game, and it's nice time to get to spend with the guys, of course. Rather than that, yeah, they just gotta figure out, get your legs under you early on, and just hopefully they stick with you the whole game.
All right, Nolan, thanks for joining us. Appreciate the time.
Yeah, thank you for having me.
Back with more of the first period intermission in just a moment. This is River Dragons Hockey.
Sacramento with 8 shots. The River Dragons end up with 12 shots on goal. Power plays 1-for-3 for Carolina, and the River Dragons 0-for-1 with the man advantage. Let's take a look at the, actually, before we get to the Zelmo Zip-In out-of-town scoreboard, we need to keep it legal, which we like to do along the radio side. So we are going to step aside for just a moment, take a break, 10 seconds along the network for station identification.
You're listening to River Dragons Hockey on WKCN HD2 Fort Moore, Columbus, and W295 AY Crystal Valley. 106.9 really rocks.
And so now, let's get to that Zelmo Zip-In out-of-town scoreboard, shall we? As we take a look across the FPHL. Boy, how about this one? Just into the second period, the Motor City Rockers are already up 5-0 on the Elmira River Sharks in that game. And Motor City jumped all over Elmira very early in that one. Just taking a quick look at the goals in that one. All 5 of those were scored before the halfway mark of the first period. Starting at the 2:50 mark, and then 5, 6:42, 7:29, and 9:56, the time of those goals. It was 5-0 before it was halfway through that first period, and that's being played at First Arena in Elmira. So the River Sharks, while they have time to dig themselves out, they have a lot of work to do. They better get a big shovel or several of them. Elsewhere in the FPHL, we've got a 7 o'clock start coming up here. Danbury at Binghamton. That one has not gotten underway yet. Also a 7 o'clock start will be the Port Huron Prowlers at the Mississippi Seawolves. And then an 8 o'clock Eastern start will be the Blue Ridge Bobcats at the Baton Rouge Zydeco. In the National Hockey League, a couple of finals from earlier today. The Rangers 7-4 winners over the Bruins. Kings shut out the Canadiens 4-0. Coming up here at the top of the hour, you've got Sabres at Devils, Leafs at Pens, Flyers at the Islanders at the bottom of the hour, and then 3 games at 10 o'clock Eastern. Flames are at the Avs, Canucks at Sharks, and Coyotes at the Golden Knights. Let's take a look at the college football scoreboard. Boy, potential upset in the making in the Iron Bowl. Maybe, maybe not. Time ticking down on Auburn right now, and Alabama manages to score a late touchdown. Number 8, Alabama goes ahead 27-24 with 26 seconds to go in the fourth quarter. Meanwhile, number 15, Arizona has beaten Arizona State 59-23. BYU still holding on with a minute to go against Oklahoma State 24-21. Tennessee 45-17 over Vanderbilt. That one's in the fourth quarter. And Liberty, 42-28. That one looks like it's gone final now over UTEP. Also in the fourth quarter now, number 4, Washington has pulled ahead of Washington State, 21-14. Coming up later, you got Florida, Florida State, Notre Dame, Stanford, Georgia, Georgia Tech, Clemson, South Carolina, Iowa State, Kansas State, North Carolina, and NC State. Games from earlier today, finals, number 3, Michigan, 30-24 winners over number 2, Ohio State. Kentucky 38-31 over number 10, Louisville. That is a big win right there for the Wildcats. And number 14, LSU beats Texas A&M 42-30. So there's your Zelmo Zip-In out-of-town scoreboard. Boy, for just a moment there, it looked like Auburn might have a chance of the upset in the Iron Bowl. Now, of course, still a little bit of time left, but an awful lot that Auburn's going to have to do here if they're going to march it on down that field. But stranger things have happened, sports fans. I never say never. We've seen some stuff, and we will continue to see stuff, and that's why we love sports as much as we do, because you can never say never in the world of sports. That'll wrap it up for our first period intermission, brought to you by SunSouth John Deere Equipment for those that do. When we come back, we will have second period action coming up in just a little bit here for you, so stay tuned for that. Right now it's 1-0. Carolina Thunderbirds with the lead on a Panacek power play goal. Skating 5 aside when we return here for second period action. We'll have that just on the other side of the break. This is Columbus River Dragons Hockey.
It's year-end sales event time at SunSouth. Get exceptional offers on quality John Deere equipment, including available 0% financing for 72 months on popular models, including 1 Series, 3 Series, and even 5 Series tractors, along with a great selection of implements to meet your needs. Do more on your property with John Deere equipment from SunSouth. and save more during the year-end sales event. SunSouth, equipment for those that do.
Some restrictions apply. See dealer for details. Expires November 30th, 2023.
In 1999, Watley Convenience Stores opened its first Zelmo's Zip-In. Since then, the brand has grown to include 11 stores in the Chattahoochee Valley and Southwest Georgia. Zelmo's is an anchor in the communities it operates in. Our managers, employees, and vendors are all an integral part of the neighborhoods and communities we serve. We're proud to call these areas home and plan to continue growing with and serving the communities of West Georgia and East Alabama. Zelmo's, fueling life's passions.
It's the fifth anniversary season of Columbus River Dragons hockey, and RiverDragonsMerch.com has everything you need, including our new limited edition anniversary look. RDragonsMerch.com has something for all ages, with a variety of hats, shirts, jackets, and more. Plus, cool souvenir items like the always popular fan chains, pucks, and keychains. Want to order a gift for someone? We'll ship it for you. Just go online to RDragonsMerch.com.
For Beam, community isn't just a place, it's a state of mind. We believe that when we care together, work together, and even cheer for our favorite teams together, we are closer to what counts. Beam has been improving the way we connect since 1964, not just with technology, but with our communities and with each other. Because at Beam, community is not just a place, it's the way we do business. Beam, bringing East Alabama more. It's in our name.
Columbus Diagnostic Center, the area's clear choice for diagnostic imaging. CDC Northside features the area's first and only 3T MRI, the most powerful MRI available, and our new 64-slice CT scanner, cutting-edge imaging that's available at both locations. For over 30 years, patient comfort, lower costs, and uncompromising dedication remain our top priority. Clearer results for a more accurate diagnosis. Columbus Diagnostic Center and CDC Northside, technology with a human touch.
An injury can be a game changer. That's why Houston Sports Medicine Team provides urgent ortho care, Saturday morning injury clinics during hockey season, and an emergency room at Jack Houston Memorial Hospital. An injury can be a game changer, and immediate evaluation and care can be a game changer too. For more information, go to Houston.com or call 706-324-6661.
And we are back getting ready for second period action, just in time to catch the Boobirds. The River Dragons returning to the sheet here. Columbus defending the net down to the right of our broadcast location, rolling right to left on your radio dial and on your YouTube screen as well in the White Road uniforms. And now the Thunderbirds retake the ice. Don't bad guys always wear black? By the way, it has indeed gone final in the Iron Bowl. Alabama holds on for the win. Boy, oh boy, that was something. Auburn gave number 8 Alabama a run for their money all the way down to the final drive. So now the River Dragons are going to have a chance here. Maybe they'll end up with a little bit of a, actually, they didn't have a bad start. I'm going to take that back before I get too far into that thought. They didn't have a bad start at all to the first period. In fact, they carried the pace for the first couple minutes. They just weren't able to really find a way to put a goal in. Let's see if they start the second period the way they started the first with the momentum. Thunderbirds will start with the draw, though Ford in with a quick shot, saved by Joseph, a backhand right across the front of the goal mouth. That one is turned away, clear but not out. Ends up on the far side, wick line off the dasher. Ford holding it in. He'll put it in front, sticked away by Joseph. Here's Jemayev back after it. He'll backhand it around. Wickline tipping it on. Looking for King. Stick check by Ford. He keeps it in. Boy, Gus Ford is woken up in this game. His centering feet off skates and out. And now McDonald tried to turn it around. Tipped it in front out of play. Wickline with a shot from the right wing. Looked like McDonald. I wasn't sure if he was going to try to handle that pass in front. Instead, as he was pirouetting on the skates, went for the tip, directed it out. Now it's Krupp, Bersani, and Doe, along with Bockwell and Underwood. Face off to the left of Cavallari in the Thunderbirds net. Krupp encroaches early, as does Salak. They back him out, drop the puck, tied up in the skates at the dot, ends up on the wall. Bersani trying to get a piece of it, cannot. It's pulled free by the Thunderbirds. Here's Firth off the glass. Oh, he hit his own man in the mouth. Oh, boy, he caught Pastuca right in the mush. Pastuca is going to head off towards the locker room. Well, Tucker Firth went to bank that puck off the glass and smoked Pastuca right in the face with it. Oh, that's a rough one. Pastuca is going to come back out on the ice. I think he just pulled his tooth out. I think they're going to send him off. He's got to come off. Right now, the faceoff stays in the Thunderbird zone. They're looking for a way to clear the zone here. River Dragons forcing Salak this way, then that. Right now, banked onto the right wing side, and it does get to center. Bockwell stepping up to tie up Panacek, and that put the play offside, I believe, at the line. Indeed, it did. This offside brought to you by Old School Barbershop. They're online at oldschoolbarbershoppe.com. So if your sides are a little off, you can book your next appointment online right now, 24/7 through their Instagram and Facebook as well. Couldn't be any easier to look like $1 million. Visit Old School Barbershop. Thunderbirds win the drawback from just outside their blue line. They'll move it ahead, send it around the rim. Joseph out to handle it behind the net. In the far side corner, Gill chomped it up into the netting. Faceoff will stay inside the River Dragons end of things. Both teams will change it up here. Draw to the left of Joseph. And the River Dragons net tied up on the dot. Schnapp couldn't force that one through. Gill trying to move it up the near side towards Storjahan. Storjahan to the point is able to push it onto the zone. He'll get a pass across, take a bump there, but he did get it over. Moore chasing it down, but turned back by Carolina. He'll dump it in. Right to the defense. Gill off the glass, but Butita pinched it off with his body on the near wall. Schnapp with a long shot in. Joseph kicks that one well out of play. Boots that one high. And 2:01 into this second period. 1-0. Thunderbirds leading the River Dragons. Now Pastuca is going to head off the ice, by the way. Try to maybe get that bleeding in the face area taken care of. There's a quick shot off the faceoff blocked by the defenseman in front. Hunter turning it the other way for the River Dragons. He'll chip to himself and go in on the left side. Hunter in after it. Swung back up the near wall. Fort flips it away from Storjahan. He comes down at center. And it's Lahetka. Oh, that's a bad call. Lahetka's going to get an interference call. Dominic Dumas went in on Slahetka, fell into Slahetka. So the contact lasted longer than a normal bump and release, but because Dumas is a klutz, Slahetka gets interference. 2:25, time of the penalty. He's in the Abercrombie bonding penalty box here. River Dragons trying to set something up here. Firth into the left side corner. Ford after it. It is the fourth power play of the game for Carolina. They're 1-for-3. Right point. Here's Firth. Right half wall. Clay Keeley tried to send it back to him. It ends up in the right wing corner. Right point. Firth. Looking across to the far dot. Baker, backhand up top, a shot, and coming to his left, Joseph the save. Taylor Joseph with a big stop there. Good stop on the power play. Faceoff will stay to the left of the River Dragons net. Columbus will change up the penalty killers. Storjahan winning the draw. Over Shinkarik is tied up. King to help out. Flips it around to the far side. Moore finds the seam and flips it down. Thunderbirds will move it up the left side. Break in over the line. Clay Keeley now collision in behind the play. Puck up top to Firth. He'll get it back at the right point. Long shot in. That hit a shin pad. Carams to the far side. King trying to clear it. Moore on it. He'll send it down. Thunderbirds teeing up behind the net. Teams changing it up. 43 seconds to go on the power play for the Thunderbirds. 3:45 into this second period. Here's Butita driving behind the net to the near side. His feed to the point hit McDonald. Now in on goal. It's swatted down and covered by Joseph. He got the mitt over that one. Storjahan in for the faceoff here. He'll win it back into the corner. Underwood trying to peel his way free. Butita over after it. Around it goes to the left point. Salak. And he lost the roller. And now here's Doe away. Doe trying to get in on a break. On the backhand. In on goal with a shot. And Doe ends up in the net. Cavallari made the right pad save. Doe was caught by James Farmer, who knocked him down. And Doe is slow to get up. Doe is up on his own feet now and skates off. Got a rough ride into that net. Farmer was digging hard to come back, and I know McDonald is lobbying for a penalty. Will not get the favor of the call. Slaheka remains in the box for 14 more seconds. 4:11 gone here in the second period. 1-0, Thunderbirds in the lead. Puck swung over to the near wall. McDonald will keep it in. Put a shot towards the net that was wide. Now Underwood steps in over for the point. That one goes just wide. Bockwill, his shot over the crossbar. For the River Dragons, all of a sudden, with a bunch of shot attempts here, shorthanded, and now Slaheka out of the box. Columbus is at full strength. They get him out of that Abercrombie bonding penalty box. Let's see if the River Dragons could use this momentum. A little bit of anger behind him. McDonald leaves it in the slot. Wickline back door for Jamaev. Had his stick tied up at the last moment. 3-on-2. Carolina ahead. Panacek weaving it over the line. Leaves it. Force a lock. A shot blocker. Saved by Joseph. Puck goes out of play off the old waffle board. 4:55 into this second period. Taylor Joseph with a beauty. Might be opening up a little bit out there. takes off to the right of Joseph. There's a quick chance in tight, and he made the save. That swung back around on the near wing. Storjahan out to center. Here's Hunter in over the line, right side. Hunter with a back feed into the slot. Shinkarik, a shot and a blocker save. Cavallari. Shinkarik feeding it down the wall. Storjahan on it. River Dragons trying to pick the pace up here. There's Moore in with a hit on Kennedy. Kennedy got the puck around, though, and out it goes to center. Moore puts a bump on his man. Puck turned over quickly. River Dragons move it to center and dump it right back in. Moore after the puck, and he knocks down a clear. Sent right up through the slot, but Hunter couldn't knock it out of the air. Thunderbird's back. Left side, Schnapp in with a shot right into the chest protector of Taylor Joseph, and now... Well, Schnapp hooked up with Shinkarik for a moment there, but the linesman get in there. And it's time for us to get to a break. We'll be right back. Just over five gone here in period number two. 1-0 Thunderbirds. This is Columbus River Dragons Hockey.
Get ready to hoop it up this season in Trojan Arena with Troy Basketball. Combined season tickets for men's and women's basketball start at $75 for all 24 home games. You won't find a better deal than that. Get your Troy Basketball season tickets now at TroyTrojans.com/tickets. The action begins November 6th, and we want to see you all season long. Visit TroyTrojans.com/tickets and lock in your Troy Basketball season tickets now.
We're always going a million different directions.
But Kinetic Credit Union makes it easy for all of us to stay connected, all in one place.
With the Kinetic mobile app, we both can monitor our accounts on the go. We can create account alerts so we know when there's a change. Apply for a loan or credit card. We can even open a new account.
Plus, you can quickly pay bills, transfer money, or make a deposit anytime, anywhere.
Kinetic makes our life a whole lot easier.
Kinetic Credit Union, the energy for your dreams.
Welcome back. This is Columbus River Dragons Hockey. Tom Callahan here with you alongside executive producer Drew Pierce. Drew stands next to me and he clicks things and moves things occasionally, types on the keyboard. He looks busy, like he's doing some stuff. He's completely ignoring me right now. Faceoff coming up to the right of Taylor Joseph. Puck down, River Dragons control. King will put it behind the net here, slack up the left side. He'll take a bump, puck ahead. Thunderbirds have been picking up the hitting here and there. Swan's out there right now with Doe and Bersani, so we'll see if maybe the River Dragons try to get a little more physicality into the game. It's turned back just outside the line. Now it is turned over, and in on the left wing, there's a chance and a shot. That is ripped wide of the net by Farmer. Around the rim, Butina with a shot. Tip just wide of the far post. Deflected by Farmer right in front of Taylor Joseph. Swan will move it away, and the Thunderbirds are running and hitting everything right now. Shot in, and a nice stop on that wrister from the point. Joseph got the left glove on it. Puck to the line, not out. Butina gloves it down. Backdoor feed, a shot, and Joseph over to his right to make the save there. Take it away from Nate Keeley. Again, the River Dragons trying to go cross ice at their own blue line. And there was not even anyone on this wing. It was just a cross-ice dump, and Butina gloves it down, and you get a 2-on-1 for the blue line in. Shooting yourself in the foot when you do that. 6:36 gone in the second, 1-0. River Dragons trailing the Carolina Thunderbirds here. The back half of a home-and-home won last night in a shootout, 2-1 by the Thunderbirds. Dump back into the River Dragons end of things. Quick line, get it back to the Carolina blue line. Underwood chasing in after it. He'll loop out from behind his own net. And he'll move it up the left side. Too far for McDonald. Bockwell banking it back towards Jemayev. And again, pushed in by Carolina. Salak tied up on the far side. Wickline hooks it out of the zone. Sent off the glass and out to center. Kicked in by Bockwell. Jemayev has to tag up, and then he moves up on the forecheck here. There's Bockwell at center on the loose puck. Knocked down by McDonald on the right side as he tries to get up after it. Cleared towards the line, off Jemayev, not out. Jemayev swings it to an open corner. Kennedy up the wall, he takes a bump. Pastuca on the right side. Now dumped in from center by Bione. Joseph out to play it. He'll fling it up ahead to Jemayev, who catches it. Gives it to McDonald. McDonald chipping it in behind Moore. River Dragons looking to go for a change here as Underwood throws it back in. Moore up on the forecheck here. Carolina fans on a pass up the right side. They're going to try to go back to the left and now get back to the right side. That's where they want to go for this breakout. Second attempt, so far so good. Ford carries out to center, lost the handle. Pass for Storjohn, too far in front of him. He kicks it back across the ice. Here's Shinkarik into the rush. Shinkarik on the right side. In with a shot off the right shoulder of the goaltender, Cavallari. Gill with a shot and a glove save. Cavallari will hold. 8:34 gone here in the second, and the River Dragons some signs of life offensively. Maybe their best couple of forays of the game so far. The second period is brought to you by WOW Internet. The Columbus River Dragons are proud to partner with WOW again this season. Team up with WOW Internet and YouTube TV. It's a good deal for sports fans. Go Dragons! Thunderbirds win control of the faceoff. And they will wedge it out to center, but it's knocked down there by Columbus. However, Moore lost it. And now again, D to D for the Thunderbirds. They'll go up the left side. Pass through center, deflected off at the line. Never gets into the zone. Storjohn turning it up the left side. And now Hunter in on the wing. Intercepts. In with a shot. He scores! Ryan Hunter! A wrist shot as he goes high to the stick side of Cavallari. It's his first professional goal. And Ryan Hunter ties this game up at one. What a shot, 9-11 time of the goal, and boy, it's so prophetic. Talking about Hunter in the pregame, saying he's one of the guys you'd like to see get on the score sheet and you hope can contribute offensively for this team, and he could not pick a better time. Well, that was absolutely wired. One of the few clean shots Columbus has had in this period. And they cash it in. Storjohn with an assist and offside whistled down. And that offside is brought to you by Old School Barbershop. They're online at oldschoolbarbershoppe.com. Need to get your sides lined up? Book online anytime, 24/7 through their Instagram and Facebook as well. The River Dragons forced back into their own end. Slahetka does get the puck just over the blue line before it's backhanded in. And now Columbus on it again. King to the near side, Slahetka. Long lead to center. Blocked there and tossed right back in. Carolina offside, they have to tag it up. River Dragons have a moment. Now a clear. That one went right off the face of Schnapp. As Slahetka tried to float it out of there. The whistle goes as he heads to the bench. He is the second Thunderbird to take a clearing attempt in the face tonight. Pastuca earlier, and now Schnapp. 7 seconds shy of the halfway mark of period number two. It's 1-1 tie here at the Annex in Winston-Salem. McDonald in for the faceoff, wins it away from Panacek. Bockwell over to Underwood. Back to Bockwell, and his clearing attempt blocked. 3-on-2 developing quickly. Panacek in, up top shot, and way out to make the save. Joseph gobbles that one up. That'll get us to the media timeout. 9:55 left to go here in the second. Tied at one, Ryan Hunter gets the River Dragons right back to even with the Thunderbirds. This is Columbus River Dragons Hockey.
I'm always on the go. But with the Kinetic Credit Union app, Kinetic is always with me. The Kinetic mobile app is virtual banking at its best. With the Kinetic mobile app, I can easily send and receive money, make a deposit, pay some bills, and I can even open up a new account, all from my phone. And I can monitor all my accounts in one place, all on the go. The Kinetic mobile app. Energized banking at its best.
Kinetic Credit Union. The energy for your dreams.
No matter how large or small your digging project may be, no matter how urban or rural, you must always call 811 before any digging project. 811 is our national one-call number, alerting your local utility companies to come out and mark any lines they have near your dig site. So before you do this or this, make sure you do this. For digging projects big or small, make the call to 811, brought to you by Common Ground Alliance.
And we're back here at the Winston-Salem Fairgrounds. Tom Callahan here with you. For the fake shot to the left of Taylor Joseph. He's seen 19 shots from the Thunderbirds. Mario Cavallari seen 17 for the River Dragons. Both goaltenders have let one by. Tied at one, halfway home here in this hockey game. Draw one back to the point. Pastuca, quick shot. Save made. Rebound sitting there. Salak could not fight his way free for a shot. He had Bockwell draped all over him. Now a centering attempt, that one is golfed back behind the net. Ends up with Jemayev on the near side. Jemayev out to center, Wickline chasing onto the right wing. Can't get there in time as it's turned back into the zone. McDonald leaving it for Jemayev. Jemayev pushing in left wing, swings it around the wall, onto the far side, cutting over the right point, Underwood. Backing it up, McDonald, keeping it in with a shot in on goal and a save made Cavallari. Looks like it might have been deflected on the way through. Cavallari, a nice save. And he holds on. River Dragons are going to put out Hunter, the goal scorer, between Storjahan and Moore. Hunter in for this faceoff. And Hunter in front, a quick feed from Moore. He jams away, looking for his second of the game. Cavallari able to hold on. I'll tell you what, though, Hunter went right to the net, and Moore fed it to him quickly. That's what the River Dragons need. Bonnie's in front, take away the eyes of the goaltender, and boy, get those pucks in. Face off to the right of the Thunderbirds net. One back to the point. Shankara can leave it off. Here's Moore. Near wall. Rister had traffic. Blocked, but it came right back to him. Now he's looking in front. Feeds it up top. And a shot that's blocked off the shin pads. And now the other way, the Thunderbirds on the right side. Here's Ford. Ford has Hunter on the back check on him. River Dragons trying to move it out of there. Hunter leaves for Gill. Storjahan. Moves it ahead, Shinkarik into the rush. He'll feed right side. Moore chips it back ahead, too far for Shinkarik. As it's cleared back the other way, off the glass, not out. Storjahan holding it in, only for a moment. As it was chopped out of his skates, sent up with Gill back at the blue line. Gill feeds it ahead, Hunter tips it in. River Dragons go for the change. Krupp up on the forecheck. He'll get it around towards Storjahan. Storjahan to the left side, left point, Shinkarik. Shinkarik's got room, middle of the ice, wrist shot, save Cavallari, and he holds. Columbus has that seesaw going back the other way right now. They have had some pretty darn good offensive chances here in the last little bit. See if they can keep the ball rolling. Face off to the right of the Thunderbirds net. Bione after it. Just tipped on a clearing attempt. Comes down just in front of the River Dragons bench. Slahetka, left side to Doe. Joe went over the line. Left half wall looking in front. Pass forced behind as Firth deflected it. Now Doe puts a bump on his man. Puck free. Bione will pick it up. He'll come up the left side. Gutita could hang on to the pass. Lahetka able to clear it back out as he's pulled down. And a penalty coming up. It's going to be a tripping call. 7:49 left to go in this second period, and the River Dragons going back to the loft power play with a roll for one. Bione getting in the box. Not happy about it, but getting in the box. 12-11 time of the penalty shots are even at 20, goals are even at 1. The Loft features live music every Friday and Saturday night. Show your River Dragons ticket stub for 2-for-1 cover. River Dragons have to chase the puck down as a clear over the head of Gill to start things off here. And there's Shinkarik. He'll carry ahead, as Wickline with him. Shinkarik on the right side, delays, waits for everyone to catch up with him. Feeds to an open wing. McDonald trying to get to it, cleared away and down. Shinkarik back for it. He'll bring it ahead onto the wing. Wickline gets through a check, lost his helmet on the play. He's got to head off the ice. And now the referee falls, trying to get the helmet out of the way. Puck ends up on the near side. Jemayev lost his stick in the play, and now it's cleared out. Only man back here is Ryan Hunter. He's got to take it away from Ford and does. Now he moves up with speed through center. It's cleared to the line. McDonald on it. Tried to dump it back the other way. Hunter in space lost it. Ford hustling back on the right wing. One on four. Spins back. And he'll feed it back to the D to kill time. Now on the change, moving in. Here's James Farmer with a chance, fought off by the glove of Taylor Joseph. Now Columbus must go the other way. This is awful helter-skelter for a power play. In on the left side, here's Hunter, leaving it up top. Storjohan, let's see if the River Dragons take advantage of the chaos. Left side corner, Storjohan lets it go to the left point. Slahetka settles. Over to the right side to King. King back up top. Slahetka, his shot off the goalpost. King on the right side, a clear goes off a skate. Now potential 2-on-1. Gutin up the left side, Moore is back to take away the man. Here's a chance, a shot and a save made by Joseph. Schnapp jumped in, third man into the rush, had a chance but didn't get much on it. Seconds to go in the Loft power play for the River Dragons. Tied at one with 6:04 to go in the second. And boy, it has been an absolutely chaotic power play. Both ends, lots of rushing up and back. You don't want to get into a track meet when you're supposed to have the man advantage, that's for sure. Draw to the left of the River Dragons net, tied up, and one back now to the point shot coming in by Kennedy, save made by Joseph. Bersani will wheel back with it, left side to Bockwell. Bione up on his skates, getting ready to get out of the box as it's dumped in. Cavallari will just pin it there and hold on. And Bione is 1 second away from getting out. So it's going to be Krupp, Bersani, Doe up front. Bockwell is already backed onto the zone, anticipating the Thunderbirds player getting out. Thunderbirds win the draw, but Doe try to steal it back and shove it towards the net. Bersani had his stick held up by Panacic. River Dragons keep it in, though, but Doe lost it on the near wall. And Carolina away to center. River Dragons 0-for-2 with a man advantage in the game. It's tied up at 1. Now here's a chance on the slot. Pastuca, glove saved by Taylor Joseph. Oh my, what a stop right there. Boy, that's a big one for Joseph with 5:28 to go in the second period. Draw will come to the right of Joseph in the River Dragons net. Shinkarik on the near side around to Jemayev, and he'll flip that one out. Back down the ice, hustling after it. Farmer feeds it up the far side. Salak takes a bump but gets it ahead. Here's Pastuca in. One-time shot. Panacic high and shouldered down. Maybe even caught the mask on Joseph. Might have busted a clip there on him. Now we get the whistle. Also might be a little bit of ringing in the old ears. And again, one of the rules that I will always lobby for, and I think makes sense, they have it in international hockey. If the goalie gets hit in the head, the whistle blows. It's a safety issue. And you certainly don't want a guy trying to stay in the play if he's staggered or might have some sort of equipment problem. In international hockey, the goalie gets hit in the head, they blow the play down. You cannot, I don't think you can hit your own goalie in the head if you need a whistle, though. River Dragons able to move it out to the zone here after a faceoff winner's McDonald. Rolling puck with a shot deflected wide of the Thunderbirds' cage. Jemayev will hook it to the point. Gill quickly over with a wrist shot and tipped on goal. Cavallari a blocker save on the redirect. Jemayev trying to get to it, cannot as it's cleared ahead. Thunderbirds move ahead here left side. On to the right wing, Baker. He was fronted immediately by Shinkarik. His shot block goes into the corner. And boy, body spilling everywhere over there. Shinkarik back up on the skates as the puck up the near wall. McDonald takes a hit, gets it across. Shinkarik on it. Pass block came back to him. He'll feed it ahead now. Wickline on the left side. Whistle down offside. 4:20 to go in the second. We're tied at one. We'll step aside and take a break. Back with more in just a moment. This is River Dragons Hockey.
Even though I'm away at college, Kinetic Credit Union is still the best way for me to stay connected here and at home. With the Kinetic mobile app, I have control of my accounts wherever I go. I can easily transfer money between internal and external accounts, get money faster by setting up recurring transfers, and I can find the nearest ATM or branch right from my phone. Plus, I can add my Kinetic cards to my phone's digital wallet and enjoy quick, secure, contactless payments. By the way, Mom, I need some more money.
Kinetic Credit Union, the energy for your dreams.
For Beam, community isn't just a place, it's a state of mind. We believe that when we care together, work together, and even cheer for our favorite teams together, we are closer to what counts. Beam has been improving the way we connect since 1964. Not just with technology, but with our communities and with each other. Because at Beam, community is not just a place, it's the way we do business. Beam, bringing East Alabama more. It's in our name.
Second period is brought to you in part by WOW Internet. Once again, partnering with the River Dragons this season. The Columbus River Dragons and WOW are teaming up. WOW Internet and YouTube TV. It's a good deal for sports fans. Let's go, River Dragons. Check them out online and sign up for service. As a matter of fact, you don't even have to go in anymore. You can sign up for everything, get service right at your address by doing it all online. You can do everything online. We tell you, you can book your haircut online, you can get your internet online, you can do everything online. You can bank online with Kinetic Credit Union. King going back for the puck in the River Dragons end. 4 minutes to go in the second. This game's tied up at one. Chipped in around the glass. Lahetka behind his own net. Takes a bump as he gets it around to Moore. Moore will lift it out towards Storjahan. Storjahan will fire it into the left side corner. Hunter has it paddled away by Cavallari, but is kept in by Moore up top. Storjahan into the skates of Hunter. Couldn't shoot. Right point, King does let it go. It pinballs off a body. Wraparound attempt coming, and Moore's feed was blocked. Moore knocked down in the corner. And now Butito away with it. Feeding it back, Slaheka tried to sweep it onto the zone. It's pushed deep towards Schnapp. On the left side, there's a shot coming in, deflected in front of Joseph. Ends up on the near side. Hunter on it. Chips it ahead. And the bouncer back with Kennedy. Hunter flings it in. River Dragons moving up. Here's Austin Doe on the forecheck. Full team slowing it down, working through a change here. Panacek is all the way inside the River Dragons blue line, looking for a long pass. Schnapp will skate it ahead. Schnapp in on the right wing, trying to drive in. He's ridden wide by King, then run into by Bockwill. Puck jarred loose, King on it. He'll get it across to Doe, who had it chopped off his stick. Bockwill with it. Puts it across right side. Bersani chasing into the corner. Behind the net, Kennedy on the near side. Panacek through center, and now that's picked off by Underwood. Quickly back, Bersani moving in. Three on two if they hurry. Feed in front. Oh, that one tipped just on the back side of the net, but No real scoring chance out of it. Comes around to the left point. Blackwell holding his shot through traffic. That one is blocked. Oh, and his skates up towards the blue line. Can't keep it in. Salak run into by Underwood. Blackwell over to get the puck. Now Salak pulls it down again, moving in, and Underwood got body position on him to twist him away from it. Kept in though, Pastuca with a high shot and a blocker saved by Joseph. Now back the other way, here come the River Dragons. McDonald dumping it in right on goal. Cavallari leaving there for Kennedy, who I don't think expected that. Pastuca has to lift a wedge back out to center. Caught by Underwood. He'll backhand it in. McDonald has it come up the near side. Wickline after it. Wickline, backdoor feed, they score! Alexander Jemayev at the back post. What a feed by Wickline as Jemayev knocks that puck in out of the air. Great hand-eye coordination, and with just 1:31 to go in the second period, Jemayev records his eighth goal of the year to give his team the lead. Wow, what a goal by Alexander Jemayev. And boy, that line continues to contribute for this River Dragons team. Good to see him back on the score sheet here after being held off it last night. Well, partially held off it last night. Gill picking up an assist as well. Cavallari came out to play the puck. Jemayev took a route around him to the net and knocked his goal stick out of his hand. Fans wanted a penalty, none coming. There's a pass deflected back in the River Dragons end by McDonald. And now Baker ends up down on the ice. It is gonna get chippy in the last minute of play here in this second period. Shinkarik leaves it back towards Gill. Gill ahead to Wickline. Wickline leaving it back to Gill. Gill pushing up the left side and over the line. He's got room in the slot. Gill trying to cut through and into the left side corner after it. Wickline wanted the puck in the slot, didn't get it. Has to throw a hit on Firth instead. Shinkarik at the line, delays, waiting for the play to get back onside. 30 seconds to go. Played ahead. Here's Torjahan stepping in. Hooks it back into space. Too far back for Moore. That allows a pass ahead to Ford. Ford back towards Salak. Salak in over the line. Hooked up by Moore from behind. River Dragons a chance if they hurry. Time winding down to the period. Moore driving the left side into the corner. Torjahan behind the net. And it'll be taken away by Salak. 10 seconds to go here, but it's still in the offensive zone. Left side, King pushing down for the point, feeds it in front of pinballs up top. Slaheka rolling puck, block, another chance, save Cavallari, and he holds on right at the horn, and now we get the pushing and shoving. Storjahan going at it with Firth. And that forms a pile. Yep, it is gonna be a feisty fight to the finish. In the third period here, when we get around to it, there is no love lost between these two teams. They didn't like each other last year. It did not improve over the summer whatsoever. Okay, we finally have reached the end here of the second period, and to the advantage of the River Dragons. How about that? Columbus scores twice. Hunter and Jemayev, we'll tell you about those goals. We'll talk about the second period. We'll get you that Zillow zipping out of town scoreboard. We're gonna do a whole lot more. Man, plenty of action here in the second, and good stuff if you're a River Dragons fan, as they come in trailing 1-0 and leave leading 2-1. Let's step aside and take a break. Our second period intermission is brought to you by Shredaway. We'll be back on the other side of these commercial messages with more Columbus River Dragons hockey.
Let Shredaway, a division of the Overby Company, take care of all your document shredding needs. We can design a custom shredding program for your business today. No need to purchase equipment, no maintenance expenses, no need to prepare records for destruction, increase employee productivity, increase security, no worry. Was it really destroyed? Right now, all new customers can receive 10% off. Shredaway, a division of the Overby Company, locally owned and operated in downtown Columbus. That's Shredaway, 706-577-9668.
Phoenix Eye Clinic, located inside the Optical Shop in Phoenix City, wants to be your local eye doctor. Specializing in diabetic eye exams, glaucoma treatment, and cataract evaluations, Phoenix Eye Clinic has an ophthalmologist on staff. They also handle all of your needs for eye exams, glasses, and contacts. Call the Phoenix Eye Clinic at 334-480-4015. That's 334-480-4015. Phoenix Eye Clinic, located inside the Optical Shop.
If you're looking for quality dental work, look no further than Largeman Dental in Columbus, the River Dragons' trusted oral care provider. Largeman Dental provides cleaning services, restorative work, cosmetics, prosthetics, and Invisalign braces too. Dr. Largeman has over 19 years of clinical experiences in all phases of dentistry and holds memberships in four different esteemed dental societies. Set your next appointment by calling 706-322-6581 or visit them online at largemandental.com.
For Beam, community isn't just a place, it's a state of mind. We believe that when we care together, work together, and even cheer for our favorite teams together, we are closer to what counts. Beam has been improving the way we connect since 1964, not just with technology, but with our communities and with each other. Because at Beam, community is not just a place, it's the way we do business. Beam, bringing East Alabama more. It's in our name.
Get ready to hoop it up this season in Trojan Arena with Troy Basketball. Combined season tickets for men's and women's basketball start at $75 for all 24 home games. You won't find a better deal than that. Get your Troy Basketball season tickets now at TroyTrojans.com/tickets. The action begins November 6th, and we want to see you all season long. Visit TroyTrojans.com/tickets and lock in your Troy Basketball season tickets now.
Announcing Wade Cleaner's newest location at 6801 River Road, located just across from the new VA hospital. This location has a drive-through and is open 6 days a week. Tell us you heard this and receive 25% off your first visit. Wade Cleaner's, since 1939.
Welcome back to Periods Into It here. Tom Callahan here with you as this is Columbus River Dragons hockey. We're so pleased to have you on board for this game. 2-1 right now. Your River Dragons in the lead, unless, of course, you're not a River Dragons fan, in which case, welcome anyway. But the River Dragons still have a 2-1 lead. 40 minutes into it here. Let's take a look back at the scoring and the stats from period number two. And coming into it, Thunderbirds had a 1-0 lead. Panacek a power play goal back in the first. And Columbus rolled into the second. It was interesting. I actually reversed course on a thought I was having at the very start of the second period. Because the River Dragons, as I thought about it, actually did have a pretty healthy start to the first period. They came out. They put on some pressure. They had some shots on goal. And actually did not let the Thunderbirds get off to the typical quote-unquote hometown start, where you expect one team to have a bigger advantage over another and kind of press that advantage early on. Well, the River Dragons did a nice job of that in the first five or so minutes. Now, let's follow on with that a little bit. You come on to the first period, trailing 1-0 if you're Columbus, a hard-fought first period. Into the second you go, and they didn't quite have that same kind of start. It was a little more of an even going for a while, but then, after a couple of minutes, the Thunderbirds started to put it in gear, and they had some offensive chances. Taylor Joseph playing very well tonight. River Dragons getting exceptional goaltending all season so far. But they held the fort long enough to then start the pushback of their own. Momentum always swings within the course of a period, within the course of a game. And the River Dragons ended up getting that momentum back at 9-11 of period number two. Ryan Hunter scores his first professional goal from Storjahan at that 9-11 mark. And it was a tremendous wrist shot from in tight. Hunter on the left side just wires it over the right shoulder of Mario Cavalieri. And it becomes a 1-1 hockey game at that point. So Storjahan with the assist on the Hunter goal, and we're tied up at one. So then the next thing that goes on is the River Dragons then have some time, and they're able to make some things happen offensively. They start to get some of that momentum back. They do end up with a power play not long after that. And even though they don't score on that power play, they are able to get some of the momentum once again going their way off the power play. It was a little chaotic on that power play. Carolina actually had a couple of chances in there as well. But sometimes when a team kills a penalty, they get a boost from that. Instead, I think that it pretty much remained up for grabs for a couple minutes until once again the River Dragons took the momentum back in the period. And then at 18:29, just a tremendous effort as Alexander Jemayev going to the net, going to the back post on the right side, picks a pass from Cody Wickline out of the air and bats it into the net for his eighth of the season. Wickline and Gill, the assist at 18:29. And that individual effort right there was the culmination of maybe a minute or two of some pretty sustained zone time, some continued pressure from the River Dragons, and it's nice to see them get rewarded. That's the other point I want to make here, is that the River Dragons, when you're doing the right things as a team, as a line, as a defensive unit, but sometimes you don't get the break, you don't get the bounce, you start to think to yourself, what do I need to do here? And that's not necessarily the case for the River Dragons. If you're playing the right way, you're going to the hard areas, you're making the smart plays, you don't always get the breaks, but you do get chances, and you need to keep generating chances. Eventually, they go in. If you're making the bonehead plays and you're causing turnovers and all sorts of other things, okay, well, that's a different story, and we need to talk. But the River Dragons are now looking at that second period from a standpoint of, you know what, it is back and forth. These are two very evenly matched teams. But on balance, the River Dragons finally got rewarded for the effort they've been putting in this hockey game. So now they're 20 minutes away from potentially closing it out. And if they hold on to the lead in regulation, stealing 3 points on the road. So Columbus would absolutely love to be able to do that. And so the River Dragons now, it's up to them. A couple of things I think will be key for them in this third period before we give you the final stats of the period. But one of the things they need to do is they absolutely need to stay out of the penalty box. That's an important one for the River Dragons. It's also important for this Columbus River Dragons hockey team to make sure that they don't end up in the penalty box unnecessarily. Now, they may have to take a penalty here to take away a scoring chance. Those are the ones that you kill, a good penalty, they call them. Okay, that's fine. But Carolina tries to goad you into stupid penalties. And that is what they try to do, is get under your skin, get you to retaliate. And, of course, as we all know, the retaliation is what is often called. And so that's exactly what the River Dragons are trying to avoid here as we get towards period number three. So fingers crossed Columbus can do just that. All right, let's take a break here in our second period intermission report brought to you by Shredaway. When we come back, we're going to take a look at the out-of-town scoreboard, which is brought to you by Zelmo's Zippin. And we are also going to take a look around not only the NHL, the FPHL, but we'll get you some college football updates as well. I know it's a big weekend in college football, so stay tuned for that coming up in just a little bit. 2-1 River Dragons, two periods in. We're back with more in a moment. This is River Dragons Hockey.
At the Country Inn and Suites by Radisson, you'll enjoy comfortable accommodations close to Columbus State University, Fort Benning, and, of course, the River Dragons games. Conveniently located at 1720 Fountain Court in Columbus, you'll be minutes away from all your favorite Columbus destinations. Free high-speed Wi-Fi and hot breakfast always available, too. So whether you're staying for business or for pleasure, make your next stay in Columbus a comfortable one at the official hotel partner of the River Dragons. Country Inn and Suites by Radisson.
The Jersey Shop specializes in screen printing, embroidery, direct-to-garment printing, and vinyl heat-press lettering and numbering. We provide custom t-shirts for any occasion and have a graphic designer on staff to make the logos or graphics needed to make your shirts unique. We pride ourselves on being able to deliver orders of any size at low, competitive cost with no minimum quantity. That's why the River Dragons trust the Jersey Shop for all of their uniform needs. Call 706-565-4245. That's 565-4245.
Join the voice of the River Dragons, Tom Callahan, every Tuesday night at 6 p.m. for the River Dragons Coaches Show on 106.9 Really Rocks. They'll discuss the latest happenings, upcoming games, and more.
Okay. Everything in my life is fast. I'm from Toronto. I play hockey. I drive a Civic.
Civic isn't fast.
Very fast. You won't race me out there in your F-150, though.
The River Dragons Coaches Show, every Tuesday at 6 p.m. on 106.9 really rocks.
Let Shredaway, a division of the Overbeat Company, take care of all your document shredding needs. We can design a custom shredding program for your business today. No need to purchase equipment, no maintenance expenses, no need to prepare records for destruction, increase employee productivity, increase security, no worry. Was it really destroyed? Right now, all new customers can receive 10% off. Shredaway, a division of the Overbeat Company, locally owned and operated in downtown Columbus. That's Shredaway, 706-577-9668.
It's the fifth anniversary season of Columbus River Dragons hockey, and RiverDragonsMerch.com has everything you need, including our new limited edition anniversary look. RDragonsMerch.com has something for all ages, with a variety of hats, shirts, jackets, and more. Plus, cool souvenir items like the always popular fan chains, pucks, and keychains. Want to order a gift for someone? We'll ship it for you. Just go online to RDragonsMerch.com. So light 'em up, up, up. And we return here with River Dragons hockey in the second period. Intermission brought to you by Shredaway. And the River Dragons up 2-1 on the Carolina Thunderbirds. It occurs to me, I didn't give you the final numbers from that period as far as shots on goal, which were in favor of the Carolina Thunderbirds, 18-13. Right now, shots showing is 27 for Columbus, 26. Although the period, for some reason, two shots are credited in the third period. So it might have been 18-15 for the shots in the period. But 27-26 right now overall in the game in favor of the River Dragons, who have that 2-1 lead. Power plays. Also, the Thunderbirds 1-for-4. The River Dragons 0-for-2 with a man advantage. Okay, now we can move on over to that Zelmo zipping out of town scoreboard we were talking about just a moment ago. And a very busy night in the FPHL, as it tends to be on a Saturday night. Motor City raced out to a 5-0 lead over the Elmira River Sharks halfway through the first period. Now they are just into the third period, and Motor City has stretched that advantage to 7-2 over the hometown River Sharks, as Elmira struggling here a little bit early on in the season. Danbury and Binghamton, that's always a good matchup. They're tied up at 1 that game early on in the second period. Underway in Mississippi, where the Seawolves have a 2-1 lead over the Port Huron Prowlers after the first period of action there. And just dropping the puck here at the top of the hour, Blue Ridge is at the Baton Rouge Zydeco. That is the last game to get underway in the FPHL tonight. And the NHL, a couple of finals from earlier today. Rangers 7-4 over the Bruins. Kings 4, Canadiens nothing. Devils out to a 4-0 first period lead over the Buffalo Sabres. Wow, how about that one? Leafs 2-1 up on the Penguins at the first intermission. Flyers and Islanders scoreless halfway through the first. Then 10 o'clock starts in the Eastern time zone. You got the Flames at the Avalanche, Canucks at Sharks, and the Coyotes are at the Golden Knights. Then in the college football realm, it is a big Saturday of action here. So let's tell you what's going on right now. Florida has an early 7-0 lead over number 5, Florida State. Notre Dame 14-13, the 18th ranked Irish over Stanford. That game's in the second. Number 1 Georgia trails Georgia Tech 7-0 early in the first quarter. Number 24 Clemson 7-0 over South Carolina in the first. Later, you have Iowa State at Kansas State, North Carolina at NC State. Finals from earlier, number 15, Arizona, 59-23, blows out Arizona State. Number 8, Alabama, 27-24. Took a late touchdown for the Crimson Tide to get past the Tigers, but they do so in the Iron Bowl today. Oklahoma State pulls off the comeback win. Number 20, Oklahoma State comes back to beat BYU in double overtime, 40-34. Number 21, Tennessee, 48-24 over Vanderbilt. Number 25, Liberty, 42-28 winners over UTEP. Number 4, Washington, 24-21. They beat Washington State. Number 3, Michigan, 30-24 over number 2, Ohio State. And then an upset, Kentucky, 38-31 over number 10, Louisville. And
Number 14 LSU beats Texas A&M 42-30. Thatcher's Elmo zipping out of town. Scoreboard, we'll take a break. When we come back, it'll be time to drop the puck on third period action. 2-1 River Dragons leading the Thunderbirds. Stay tuned. This promises to have an exciting conclusion here this evening. Period number three on the way. This is Columbus River Dragons Hockey.
Let Shred Away, a division of the Overbeat Company, take care of all your document shredding needs. We can design a custom shredding program for your business today. No need to purchase equipment, no maintenance expenses, no need to prepare records for destruction, increase employee productivity, increase security, no worry. Was it really destroyed? Right now, all new customers can receive 10% off. Shred Away, a division of the Overbeat Company, locally owned and operated in downtown Columbus. That's Shred Away, 706-577-9668.
In 1999, Watley Convenience Stores opened its first Zelmo's Zip-In. Since then, the brand has grown to include 11 stores in the Chattahoochee Valley and Southwest Georgia. Zelmo's is an anchor in the communities it operates in. Our managers, employees, and vendors are all an integral part of the neighborhoods and communities we serve. We are proud to call these areas home and plan to continue growing with and serving the communities of West Georgia and East Alabama. Zelmo's, fueling life's passions. Columbus, Georgia is considered by some as the hockey town of the South, boasting pro hockey since 1996. But 80 years before that first puck drop, another Chattahoochee Valley favorite got its start, Piggly Wiggly. Come on down to find a great selection of fresh meats and produce for your family's next meal or your next tailgate. We're proud to root for the hometown River Dragons because we've been the hometown team since forever. Piggly Wiggly, down home, down the street.
Vector Ply Corporation is a world-leading manufacturer of carbon, fiberglass, and Kevlar composite fabrics located in Phenix City, Alabama. Our customers depend on us to produce iconic brands such as Malibu and Nautique Boat and the historic C8 mid-engine Corvette. Even the light poles surrounding the Columbus Civic Center were produced by a Vector Ply customer using Vector Ply fabrics. If you're looking for an exciting career with a growing manufacturer located right here in the Chattahoochee Valley, visit our website, vectorply.com.
We know that juicy, cheesy, grilled-to-perfection burger sounds amazing, but it does sound like something is missing. Pepsi, baby! The yin to this burger's yang, burgers and Pepsi go together like, well, like burgers and Pepsi. This perfect blending of flavors makes every bite of lettuce, every sesame seed on the bun, and every sip of that crisp, refreshing, ice-cold cola a journey to Foodtopia. Burgers, better with Pepsi. That's what I like.
Columbus Diagnostic Center, the area's clear choice for diagnostic imaging. CDC Northside features the area's first and only 3T MRI, the most powerful MRI available, and our new 64-slice CT scanner, cutting-edge imaging that's available at both locations. For over 30 years, patient comfort, lower costs, and uncompromising dedication remain our top priority. Clearer results for a more accurate diagnosis. Columbus Diagnostic Center and CDC Northside, technology with a human touch.
And we're back. Third period action getting ready to go here. You can hear the cowbells as retaking the ice, the Carolina Thunderbirds. Tom Callahan here with you for period number three. Third period action is brought to you by Kinetic Credit Union. And the River Dragons come into this Kinetic Credit Union third period, holding a 2-1 lead. Love to see the River Dragons either hold or extend said lead. And they're going to start Wickline, Jemath McDonald. Boy, McDonald is just very happy to always be talking to the referees. Always trying to just a little bit here, a little bit there, making sure you're just quietly inside their earlobe, or sometimes loudly inside their earlobe. I will tell you this, J-Mac is not shy. You want to know what he thinks, ask him, he'll tell you. And even if you don't ask him, he may tell you anyway. Puck down, we're underway. River Dragons rolling left to right on your radio dial here to start period number three or on our YouTube camera. We appreciate you being here. And there's McDonald in with a backhand try that's blocked as Columbus pushes on in. Thunderbirds will clear it out. King steps up to poke it away, though, and Lane King puts it in, but now it's turned right back out again by the Thunderbirds. Up the left side, pushing ahead is Dominic Dumas. He's ridden off the puck. Slahetka on the far side, trying to reverse it around. McDonald up the wall. Wickline tips it out to center. Thunderbirds already starting a change here. River Dragons do likewise as it's dumped in. King rubs his man out on the wall. Slahetka after the loose puck behind his own net. Sends it around towards Bersani. He'll give it back to Slahetka. Quickly right side to King. King to center for Krupp off the heel of his skates. Doe trying to catch up with it instead. Clear to the line, but not out. Krupp holding it in around the rim it goes. Cavallari out to play it. He leaves it for his D, but Doe trying to get to it. Hooked up by the goaltender a little there. Bersani over to help out. Doe, kick to the line, held in by Underwood. His shot was blocked. And now, oh boy, Bach, well, the train was on the tracks. He almost had a chance to throw a big hit there on Pastuca, and he hurt him and spun away. That allows Krupp to move in. He's knocked down. Quick shot, left pad save as Bersani let it go, and Cavallari makes that stop on the doorstep. Wow, that was an important stop here early on in the third period, just a buck 25 into it. 2-1 your score. River Dragons in the lead and now having a quick huddle here. Hunter talking to his line mates and even Gill about where the straw may go. Now actually Moore's going to take it and Moore's going to get thrown out of it. Took too long to get in there. Hunter in and it's won back by the Thunderbirds. Schnapp on it. Into the skates of Storjohn, turned over. There's a shot by Hunter, save made by Cavallari. Swung around to the right point. Gill down the boards, holds in on the backhand. Storjohn in the corner, spun down to the ice over there. Played back up the wall. Gill could only hold momentarily. And now Schnapp will push up the right side. In with a shot right into the gut of Taylor Joseph. He'll hold on to it. Want to remind everybody, our next Eve of the Dragons event at Applebee's on Airport Thruway is Thursday, November 30th at 5 p.m. Great chance to meet the team, get pictures, autographs, and check out the new holiday combos starting at just $13.99 for a limited time. Come eat with the Dragons on Applebee's Airport Thruway, Thursday, November 30th at 5 p.m. There's a shot coming in from the point off that faceoff that goes wide. Handled by Slahetka, he'll move it ahead. Pass in the air, McDonald couldn't catch it. That's icing. And we'll go back down the other way. River Dragons hockey also brought to you in part by BKI Accounting, a new age approach to old school accounting, specializing in payroll, bookkeeping, income, and sales taxes for small businesses. Learn more at BKIaccounting.com. Draw to the left of Joseph. And it's still in the circle. They fight for it. Wickline tried to clear. McDonald does backhand it out of there. Thunderbirds on the regroup. Slahetka ends up with it inside the line. Feeds Wickline. Wickline on the backhand to center. He'll dump it in. Cavallari out to play it. And ends up McDonald slot. Wickline couldn't corral it in time to shoot. Tried to leave it up top. It was blocked. Oh boy, if Wickline could have come down with that one sooner and corralled it for a shot, he had a glorious opportunity. A couple of times, Cavallari's been caught fishing. Now turned over in the high slot. Wickline again to his right side. A shot, pad save, rebound over to the left wing wall. And Swan runs into his man. Puck stays in. Wickline traps it in the corner. Swan trying to get in there after it, and Swan's going to go to the box. And he pulled down Baker. Now the trailing referee saw that one plain as day. Sequoia Swan is gonna head to the Abercrombie bonding penalty box. Much to the delight of the Carolina fans. 2:59, time of the penalty. Fifth power play of the game for Carolina. They're 1-for-4. I believe they're going to call that one tripping. Could be interference as well. Either way, River Dragon shorthanded. Tripping it is. Pastuca over to the right side into the slot for Butita. That one is checked away to the line but not out. Storjahan thought it came out. Lobbied for the offside. Doesn't get it. And so now the River Dragons trying to clear this out here. Cannot. Kept in on the left wing side. Schnapp to the left side corner. Salak spins back up to the left point. Pastuca. Salak left half wall. Schnapp in the corner. Fed towards the point, picked off by Moore. He's got all day, just wanders through neutral ice, wanders into the zone, and he'll just chip it into the corner where Austin Doe goes after it. Carolina now turning back the other way. They'll come in, look to set things up right side. There's a backdoor feed, got all the way through, nobody there for it, and it ricochets up to Bersani. Bersani will dump one in right on goal. Cavallari plays it aside. Bersani over to get it. He'll tie up his man to the far side. Good job right now for the River Dragons on this kill. Thunderbirds trying to stretch it ahead here. 41 seconds left to go in the penalty against Sequoia Swan. 2-1 River Dragons. 4:25 gone here in period number three. Thunderbirds pushing into the right side. Ford in with a shot, save made. Rebound is cleared away, and a roller out to center. Firth back after it. And Ford, he lost it. Here's McDonald looking for a shorthanded chance. In with Jemaf. McDonald, a shot fought off by the left arm of Cavallari, who holds on. And he'll get the whistle, and might have to check the mask a little bit here. Looked like he took that one up high. River Dragon showed some pretty good energy on this penalty kill. McDonald and Jemaf chatting as they swing by one another before this faceoff. 10 seconds left to go until Swan's out of the Abercrombie Bonding penalty box. 2-1 your score. Columbus in the lead. Jemaf has the go-ahead goal. Alexander Jemaf is tied for the league lead with 4 game winners. If this score holds, it would be his 5th. And we haven't played a lot of hockey yet. Knack for timely goal scoring. How about it? So now the Thunderbirds able to control that draw and move it out. Swan up on his skates, ready to come out of the box. Offside whistle down. And we will get a break right at the 5-minute mark of period number 3. 2-1 River Dragons. Let's step aside. We'll come right back with more in just a moment. This is Columbus River Dragons Hockey.
It's year-end sales event time at SunSouth. Get exceptional offers on quality John Deere equipment, including available 0% financing for 72 months on popular models, including 1 Series, 3 Series, and even 5 Series tractors, along with a great selection of implements to meet your needs. Do more on your property with John Deere equipment from SunSouth, and save more during the year-end sales event. SunSouth, equipment for those that do.
Some restrictions apply. See dealer for details. Expires November 30th, 2023.
It's the 5th anniversary season of Columbus River Dragons hockey, and RiverDragonsMerch.com has everything you need, including our new limited edition anniversary look. RDragonsMerch.com has something for all ages, with a variety of hats, shirts, jackets, and more. Plus, cool souvenir items like the always popular fan chains, pucks, and keychains. Want to order a gift for someone? We'll ship it for you. Just go online to rdragonsmerch.com.
Back of the annex, Winston-Salem Fairgrounds. Pretty busy place here tonight. Certainly plenty of cowbell action, if that's your kind of thing, if you're a Will Ferrell fan. We all know how Christopher Walken feels about it. Face off outside the River Dragons line is won back by Hunter Bersani. And the River Dragons push up to center. Bockwill will bounce it in. 5-on-5 hockey once again. River Dragons have killed off another one here. Thunderbirds are 1-for-5 with a man advantage tonight. Underwood has to chase it back into his own end. Scoops it around to the near side. And that one, they say no icing. So Cavallari way out to sweep it behind the net. Bersani, Krupp, and Doe. They're up front right now for this River Dragons team. Pushing up on the left side is Pastuca. Slides around a check from Underwood. Bockwill in the corner. Trying to pull it free. And a pile of skates over there. Krupp digging in for it as well. Salak leaning on Bockwill. Puck moved about a foot. Now it's pulled out by Krupp. And flipped to the, on the backhand of the line. Not out. Shot misses the net from the right point. Doe on it. Right side to Bersani. Bersani in his skates has to pull it back to the D. Bockwill back to Bersani. Bersani trying to get it ahead here. Loops back inside his own line. He'll carry it back while the River Dragons change it up. Both teams, in fact, will change up the personnel. 6.5 gone in the third. Fans getting impatient here because the River Dragons are content to just hang out until the breakout materializes. And here's Justin McDonald. Takes a pass from King, skates it ahead. In over the line, McDonald. Into the left wing corner, off angle chance. Found the glass. Right points, Lehetka holding it in behind the net. McDonald on the backhand, trying to pull his way free. Spins it back near side, Jemayev up top. It's Lehetka, middle of the blue line, back to Jemayev. Jemayev tees it up, and a save, Cavallari. Rebound into the near side. Wickline arriving with a thump there, trying to free that puck. Battle on the wall, Ford had it knocked away. Comes up the near side boards, backhanded along. It does get to center. And now Ford, left wing, trying to chip it in front. He does, backdoor chance, and that one disrupted at the last moment. Wickline helping out on the back check. Puck kept into the right point. Here's Ford after the loose biscuit behind the net, onto the near side. Wickline will send it through a seam down the ice. That's icing, but the River Dragons need just a moment to catch their breath. Not the worst play, certainly not a favorite, but sometimes you just need to get the whistle. 7:29 into this third period, 2-1 Columbus, 33-28 shots favoring the River Dragons. I'm going back to my Captain Morgan stance here in the booth because it worked last period. We scored twice, so see if I can get it to work again. It's dumped in from center. Shinkarik trying to play it around to the far side. Butina into the corner after it. Now Slahetka on the near side. It's pushed around. Here's Nate Keeley. He's picked up on the wall. And Ryan Hunter, who has his first pro goal here tonight, able to help extricate that puck. Storjahan on it. Tried to clear it. Hit Schnapp. Schnapp keeps it in right side. Schnapp behind the net. Wraps it around. And a paddle down save there by Joseph. Shinkarik out of trouble, ahead to Hunter. Hunter brings it in over the line, try to leave it up top to Moore. Moore battling, and lost it to Butito, who clears. Quick regroup by Columbus. Storjahan took a couple of whacks, dumps it into the near side corner. Firth behind the net. Firth lost a rolling puck. Schnapp just gets rid of it to center. Butito on it, chips it in, goes to the bench for a change. Shinkarik all kinds of times. He loops out the left side of the net. Up through center, Shinkarik with a bouncing puck to the blue line. Up in the air, comes down bouncing in the slot. And the line pass Bersani up the left side, moving into Salak with a shot. That one off of Gill went wide. Where did it go? It disappeared. So we get a whistle. Not entirely sure where that one went. It did not stay on the sheet, however. 8:55 gone in the third. 2-1 Columbus in the lead. Ryan Hunter, his first pro goal tonight. Then Alexander Jemayev, his eighth, which leads the River Dragons in that department. Panacek in a cross from Moore. Actually, that's Bersani, pardon me, for the faceoff. Tied up on the dot. And now pushed ahead, but nice job. Panacek was denied a scoring chance there. Bockwill read the play well. Salak behind the net. Panacek on the backhand. Back to the near side and over the far. Here's Panacek with Taylor down, and he makes a shoulder save. Another chance in front, and Joseph can't come up with a puck, but he got the whistle. Oh, boy, Taylor Joseph. Reached out for the puck, pulled it in. Only had it for a half a second before it was jammed out from under his mitt, but he got a whistle. My goodness. Joseph was down on his knees too earlier in that sequence. And one thing I like is a lot of goalies, when they go down in the butterfly, they hunch. Their shoulders get down. They don't keep that solid core. They don't stay rigid and upright. And Taylor Joseph stayed upright, kept the shoulder high, and he made that save with the top of his shoulder pads. He took as much of that net away as he could. River Dragons pushed the faceoff out and back into the Thunderbirds' end. That pass misses. That'll be icing against Carolina. 27 seconds shy of the halfway mark of period number three. 2-1 Columbus in the lead. Want to remind everybody, you can come meet and greet the River Dragons at Chick-fil-A Midland on November 29th from 5 to 7 p.m. River Dragons are going to be out there. It's a great chance to get some selfies in there with the guys, some autographs, have a couple of chicken sandwiches. Hey, if you bought a family four-pack and you have those coupons for the free Chick-fil-A sandwiches, now's your chance. Come on out and redeem them. McDonald misses with a wrist shot just wide of the net. I'll tell you more about family four-packs in a moment here. Slaheka, left point with a drive. That finds the glass and goes into the netting. River Dragons with some good possession time here and some offensive pressure. Well, those family four packs, Chick-fil-A, Midland, and Kissin 99.3 family four packs includes four tickets to a game, four hot dogs, four popcorn, four Pepsi products, and four coupons for free Chick-fil-A sandwiches. That's over $100 in value for just $40. Take advantage of this great deal brought to you by Chick-fil-A, Midland, Kissin 99.3, Buffalo Rock Pepsi, Brewster's Ice Cream, and the Columbus Civic Center. Our next family four pack date, December 16th, that's Teddy Bear Toss and Ugly Sweater Night. You can only get these through the River Dragons office. So either give us a call, 706-507-4625, 507-4625, or come on down. Regular business hours. We're not there today. We're not there tomorrow. It's Sunday. Here's Jemayev moving it ahead on the left side. He'll dump it in around the rim. It goes into the Thunderbirds' end of things. Puck out to center, and it ends up back with Underwood. Underwood, Bockwell, left side, lead ahead. McDonald tips it down. No icing. Columbus going for the change here past the halfway mark of the third. 2-1, River Dragons in the lead. Thunderbirds yesterday trailed the game 1-0 until the final minute when they pulled the goaltender and tied it, then won in a shootout. Columbus would love to avoid a repeat of that here tonight. Underwood cuts off a pass at center, trying to chip it into the right wing side. This is where the River Dragons, too, I mean, you talk about being able to take out teams and win games that you should win. This obviously a winnable hockey game when you're in the lead this late in the game. But this is where you need that third goal. Columbus has two. Now a 3-1 game is completely different than a 2-1 game. Thunderbirds back in. Here's Baker in the high slot. And, boy, bodies flying all over the place. Everybody falling down. Baker might be hurt by that. I'm not sure the order of this, but Bockwell and King both went into each other. They fell. Baker fell over one of them. And Baker was slow to get up. It almost looked like a slapstick comedy routine, except it was very serious. And Baker's taking a moment to get up here. Well, let's take a break, shall we? 9 minutes left to go here in the third period, and the River Dragons sporting a 2-1 lead. We're back with more in a moment on Columbus River Dragons Hockey.
Phoenix Eye Clinic, located inside the Optical Shop in Phoenix City, wants to be your local eye doctor. Specializing in diabetic eye exams, glaucoma treatment, and cataract evaluations, Phoenix Eye Clinic has an ophthalmologist on staff. They also handle all of your needs for eye exams, glasses, and contacts. Call the Phoenix Eye Clinic at 334-480-4015. That's 334-480-4015.
Phoenix Eye Clinic, located inside the optical shop.
Get ready to hoop it up this season in Trojan Arena with Troy Basketball. Combined season tickets for men's and women's basketball start at $75 for all 24 home games. You won't find a better deal than that. Get your Troy Basketball season tickets now at TroyTrojans.com/tickets. The action begins November 6th, and we want to see you all season long. Visit TroyTrojans.com/tickets and lock in your Troy Basketball season tickets now.
Man, I'm ready to go see some Troy basketball. I got to tell you, I used to be a big NBA guy, but now I think college basketball is where it's at. I love college basketball. It's a lot of fun to watch. Not as much fun as River Dragons hockey, and oh my goodness, Taylor Joseph almost gave one away right into the clutches of Schnapp. It just bounced wide of the net right as we come back to play here. Whew, bullet dodged. River Dragons clear it out. Adventures in puck handling with Taylor Joseph. Not that Mario Cavallari in the other net hasn't had a couple of hairy moments of his own tonight. I mean, it's not quite Dominic Hasek or Patrick Waugh-esque, but it hasn't always panned out for these guys. Although modern goaltenders, a lot of them are much better handling the puck. Here's Ford in on the left side of the River Dragons end. Puck poked away side of the net. Wrapped out in front. Oh, boy, Joseph thought he had it. He didn't. River Dragons D bails him out with a clear. Boy, now is not the time to fall asleep. Crew had his helmet knocked off, has to head to the bench. Shinkarik will loop all the way behind his own net with it. Boy, oh boy, 7:42 and counting to go here in the period, and you just don't want to fall asleep if you're the River Dragons, because if you do even for a moment, the Thunderbirds can tuck it in the back of the net and tie this game. Now here's McDonald at center trying to break up that rush. It ends up in with King. King left side, Slahetka. They battle just outside the line. Now it's fed back to King in the River Dragons end. They'll get it back across to Slahetka, left side, Jemayev. Ahead, McDonald will tip it in. And now the Thunderbirds quickly back the other way, trying to press the advantage here. They come in on the right side. Panacek, his centering feed, went off Slahetka out of the zone. That's going to force Kennedy all the way back inside his own blue line. Thunderbirds back in again. Left side, Salak trying to drive the net. Had it taken away by King. Puck in behind the net. Panacek trying to walk it out in front. He's watched by a couple white jerseys. King in the far corner. Battling with Salak. McDonald on it. He'll wedge one down the ice. It's a roller, and it will not be called icing because Cavallari left the crease like he was going to play it. And then when it looked like icing, he tried to back up, but they had already waved it off. Puck at center. Ends up with Kyle Moore. Back inside the River Dragons line. Moore chips it to himself off the dasher. Carries on up the left side. His shot hits Storjahan in the back of the legs. Storjahan just kind of stayed in the shooting path on him there. Here's Farmer moving it out to center. Bockwell trying to turn it the other way. Looping back for it. Nate Keeley. They'll feed it back to Farmer. Farmer delays. Under 6 minutes to go in this third period. 2-1 River Dragons in the lead. Trying to hold on as Farmer tried to walk it in. Got it over the line. Forced deep here. Bockwell leaving it off to Underwood. Underwood in front of his own net. Dangerous territory. Loops away from Schnapp. They'll send it around the rim. Storjahan jams it off the dasher and out. Good smart play there. Just get that puck out of the zone at this point. Doe up on the forecheck. Forcing the Thunderbirds to have to work to get it out. Turned over and sent it to Bersani. Bersani right side him with a wrist shot, floats high. Swan around to the left side. He'll throw a hit on Schnapp. Puck stays in, left point by Gill. Fed below the net. Bersani over after it. Trying to dislodge that puck in the corner from Clay Keeley. Farmer to the right side, trying to move it ahead. And Butita ends up with it. Right side, trying to walk it in. Gill, nice job to body up. And Butita had nowhere to go. Shinkarik now. He will sprint ahead. He's up by himself. Carter Shinkarik just waiting for some help. Doesn't have any. He flips it into the corner. His defense partner, Gill, was the only guy charging in. The River Dragons are changing the forward lines, though. They have the Jemayev, McDonald, and Wickline line back out there. Now Ford in. Centering attempt off the side of the net as the Thunderbirds try to go to work. Here's a chance in the slot. Baker scores. Dawson Baker was unmarked right between the hash marks. A breakdown in coverage. And he quickly one-times that one past Joseph, and the game is tied at two. It just takes that one moment. So with 4:31 left to go in the third, this game's now tied up. Moore will turn it in from center here as we did not go to our media timeout. Bucket center, River Dragons trying to dump it back in. They get it over the line. Turn back and Bockwell chasing it down. They'll move it ahead. Storjohan at center to the right side. Here's Moore. And he couldn't get that one through. Panacek on it just inside his own line. He'll wheel back with it. Send it back across as they try to figure this one out. And now left shot. Panacek walks into the backhand. Panacek leaves it up high in the slot. Nobody there for it. Joe looking to move it ahead to get it out of the zone at least. Joseph will leave it behind the net. 3.5 to go in the third. 2-2 tie. King looking for the pass up the middle. Here come the River Dragons. Right side to Jay Krupp. He'll dump it in. Puck in the corner. Backhanded away. And now the Thunderbirds to the attack. Boy, they feel the energy right now. And they're in offside, however. So played back around by Joseph. Did they blow the whistle? No, they did not. Puck comes back out. Rifled in around. Slahetka on the far side corner. Trying to play it ahead. Krupp in his skates. Finally found it. Jammed it out. River Dragons trying to go for the quick change. Here's Krupp stepping ahead. He's got help coming. Krupp trying to drive in. Bouncing puck. Lost the handle on it. King, Slahetka left side. Slahetka moving up, curling back. He's got a man right on him, had to get it across. King to center himself. Lane King rushing it in. King, wrist shot, glove, save, Cavalieri. 2:24 to go in the third. We'll go to our final break here of what could be regulation time. Tied at two. More Columbus River Dragons hockey coming your way.
Vector Ply Corporation is a world-leading manufacturer of carbon, fiberglass, and Kevlar composite fabrics located in Phenix City, Alabama. Our customers depend on us to produce iconic brands such as Malibu and Nautique Boat and the historic C8 mid-engine Corvette. Even the light poles surrounding the Columbus Civic Center were produced by a Vector Ply customer using Vector Ply fabrics. If you're looking for an exciting career with a growing manufacturer located right here in the Chattahoochee Valley, visit our website, vectorply.com.
Columbus, Georgia is considered by some as the hockey town of the South, boasting pro hockey since 1996. But 80 years before that first puck drop, another Chattahoochee Valley favorite got its start, Piggly Wiggly. Come on down to find a great selection of fresh meats and produce for your family's next meal or your next tailgate. We're proud to root for the hometown River Dragons because we've been the hometown team since forever. Piggly Wiggly, down home, down the street.
Well, this is going to be a tense conclusion to this hockey game. 2-2 tie, Columbus and Carolina. Here in the third period, Carolina scored to tie it. Shots are 34-31 in favor of Columbus. 2:24 to go here in this third period. We are 5-on-5. Faceoff to the left of Cavalieri. Wick line in for the faceoff against Panacek. Oh, boy, cleared right across. Jemayev over on it. Couldn't get a shot away. Wick line trying to help him out. Looking to pull it out. Wick line ends up with it up high. Sends it towards the goal. It's deflected wide. Pastuca will clear it down the ice. A roller, they say no icing. Blackwell will get there at the dot and put it back off the dasher to center. Thunderbirds have to wait to clear the zone. Carolina up the right side. Here's Salak stepping in on the wing. Salak in with a shot. Joseph the save, and he hangs on. Moy Underwood doing everything he possibly could to take that scoring attempt away. .148 to go in the third. With the game tied at two, we saw overtime and then a shootout last night. Will we see it again here tonight? Last night we were tied at one going into OT. Tonight we're tied at two. They get a fresh biscuit out of the basket. Faceoff coming up to the left of Taylor Joseph. Draw one back, quick shot coming in, and that one just wide on the blocker side. Around to the left point, Farmer holding it in. Into the left wing corner. Taken away, Shinkarik. Out the far side with it. Carter Shinkarik through center with speed. Carries in right side, leaves to Moore. His wrist shot punched out by the blocker of Cavallari. Moore tried to keep it in. He did momentarily, but now it's moved ahead to Schnapp. Schnapp will dump it in wide of the River Dragons net. Storjahan behind the net, hooked up, sends it around to the far side. Hunter tripped down over there, no call. Hunter again back up on his skates, trying to battle it out. Puck is cleared out to center and up the right side. Now here comes Moore. Moore up with Storjahan. He'll dump it in behind the net. Cleared back on the near side. As we are down to a minute to go in regulation time, tied at two. Here come the Thunderbirds on the left wing. They'll dump it in. That one is cleared aside. King around to the far wall. Slaheka back to King. Right side to Krupp. Krupp will lift it down into the Thunderbirds end. No icing. Krupp aggressive on the forecheck. Chases it out from behind the net. 30 seconds to go as the Thunderbirds move up ice. Right side Panacek trying to drive wide on Underwood. Has to carry it behind the net. Feeds it near side. The net is well off behind the River Dragons netminder Joseph. Not sure why, but we get the whistle on that one. It's going to be a faceoff, I believe, inside the River Dragons zone. And Joseph is wanting to know why he didn't get his whistle right away. 20.7 seconds to go here in this third period. Faceoff does stay inside to the right of the River Dragons net. And are we going to get a timeout call here? Bersani in for the faceoff. McDonald is out there as well, just in case Bersani gets tossed. Puck down. River Dragons win it back. Underwood on it. Around to the left side. River Dragons can do something if they hustle here. Doe at center at the line. Tried to backhand it in, but lost the handle on it. 9 seconds. It's back to center ice. Bockwill will fire one off a bouncing stick of the defender there. And now that'll do it. We're going to overtime. Two nights in a row. These two teams can't settle it in regulation. 2-2. As we move into the OT. The goal scoring in this one back in the first period. Panacek at 15:07 from Ford and Pastuca in the second. Ryan Hunter's first of his career. Alex Storjahan the only assist at 9:11. Then at 18:29. Alexander Jemayev, his eighth from Wickline and Gill, made it 2-1 after two in the third. Baker from Ford and Dumas has tied it up at 15:29. And so now the OT. And they're actually doing some work on that net that Taylor Joseph was in down to our left. The team switch ends in overtime. So it's 3-on-3 in the OT. Plus you got a long change. So that can make it also an incredibly interesting evening. The a long change, you can get caught out there sometimes. And a lot of times a team that starts with possession in overtime may keep it for a minute, maybe even two, while they wheel it around, set up for the chances they want. Actually, pardon me, they do not switch ends for the overtime. You'd think I'd know that by now. I've been in this league for over a year. So it's McDonald, Jemaev, and Shinkarik. Jemaev, as I mentioned earlier, with a goal in tonight's game. He's got four game winners tied for the league lead. McDonald, leading point getter for this River Dragons team, wins that draw back. And Shinkarik will find McDonald. McDonald loops it back into the River Dragons zone. Shinkarik, who's got some wheels on him, leaves it for McDonald in space. Columbus in over the line. Three across for the Thunderbirds. McDonald pulls back up. Looking for Jemaev. Shot towards the net. Tipped wide. Rebound off the end wall. And that one off the outside of the net. Jemaev couldn't quite get it to go. McDonald tried to steal it back. Now here come the Thunderbirds. Left side led by Salak. Salak leaving it off. Here's Ford. Walks into the backhand. Wrapped it around. Nope. Tried to go near Such. And Carrick blocked the pass. Now another wraparound attempt. He scores. Gus Ford tucks it inside the far post past the left pad of the goaltender Taylor Joseph. 42 seconds into overtime. The Thunderbirds skate out with the win. Past regulation for the second night in a row. Two, your final. Thunderbirds win it. We'll take a break. When we come back, we've got our Wade Cleaners three stars of the game, a final Zelmo zip in out-of-town scoreboard coming your way, and all that and more in the Pepsi postgame show. Stay tuned. We'll be right back with more in a moment. This is Columbus River Dragons Hockey.
You know that sound anywhere. It's the crisp crunch of that first nacho chip. With its perfect cheese to sour cream ratio sitting atop a layer of delicious beans, it's a sip away from perfection. That's what we're looking for. Add a delicious, refreshing Pepsi, and we've achieved absolute nacho nirvana. Because while you can pile those nachos high with every spicy, cheesy, savory topping, there's no topping a cool Pepsi finish. Nachos, better with Pepsi. That's what I like.
Announcing Wade Cleaner's newest location at 6801 River Road, located just across from the new VA hospital. This location has a drive-through and is open 6 days a week. Tell us you heard this and receive 25% off your first visit. Wade Cleaner's, since 1939.
If you're looking for quality dental work, look no further than Largeman Dental in Columbus, the River Dragons' trusted oral care provider. Largeman Dental provides cleaning services, restorative work, cosmetics, prosthetics, and Invisalign braces too. Dr. Largeman has over 19 years of clinical experiences in all phases of dentistry and holds memberships in four different esteemed dental societies. Set your next appointment by calling 706-322-6581 or visit them online at largemandental.com.
The Jersey Shop specializes in screen printing, embroidery, direct-to-garment printing, and vinyl heat press lettering and numbering. We'll provide custom t-shirts for any occasion and have a graphic designer on staff to make the logos or graphics needed to make your shirts unique. We pride ourselves on being able to deliver orders of any size at low, competitive cost with no minimum quantity. That's why the River Dragons trust the Jersey Shop for all of their uniform needs. Call 706-565-4245. That's 565-4245.
It's time to wrap up the game with the Pepsi postgame show, brought to you by Pepsi, the official soft drink of the Columbus River Dragons. Now back to the booth with Tom Callahan.
And back to wrap things up here in the Pepsi postgame show. And take a look at the Wade Cleaners three stars of the game here tonight, as chosen by the local media. Third star Mario Cavallari, Thunderbirds goaltender. Second star Dawson Baker, who had the game tying goal at 15:29 of the third period. And the first star Gus Ford, who had a goal and two assists. That goal, the game winner, 42 seconds into overtime from Salak and Butita. And those are your three stars of the game, as they are brought to you by Wade Cleaners. We'll take another break here. The Pepsi postgame show. Wrap the scoring up for you. And a final look at the Zelmo Zippin' Out of Town scoreboard. When we come back, this is Columbus River Dragons Hockey.
Is that the sound of an ooey gooey cheesy crunchy slice of P-I-Z-Z-A? Obviously. But as good as that sounds, we think it can get even better. Oh yeah, that's the sound of a freshly opened fizz-filled Pepsi. The only thing that can take this flavor medley of crunchy dough, mouth-watering cheese, and savory sauce to the next level. How about another bite? Pepsi and pizza sound like a match made in heaven and taste even better. Pizza, better with Pepsi. That's what I like.
Announcing Wade Cleaner's newest location at 6801 River Road, located just across from the new VA hospital. This location has a drive-through and is open 6 days a week. Tell us you heard this and receive 25% off your first visit. Wade Cleaner's, since 1939. Columbus Diagnostic Center, the area's clear choice for diagnostic imaging. CDC Northside features the area's first and only 3T MRI, the most powerful MRI available, and our new 64-slice CT scanner. Cutting-edge imaging that's available at both locations. For over 30 years, patient comfort, lower costs, and uncompromising dedication remain our top priority. Clearer results for a more accurate diagnosis. Columbus Diagnostic Center and CDC Northside. Technology with a human touch.
Get ready to hoop it up this season in Trojan Arena with Troy Basketball. Combined season tickets for men's and women's basketball start at $75 for all 24 home games. You won't find a better deal than that. Get your Troy Basketball season tickets now at TroyTrojans.com/tickets. The action begins November 6th, and we want to see you all season long. Visit TroyTrojans.com/tickets and lock in your Troy Basketball season tickets now.
Back here in the Pepsi postgame show, Tom Callahan with you. 3-2 overtime win for the Carolina Thunderbirds tonight over the Columbus River Dragons. Let's go back through the scoring in this game. And all the way back in the first period, the Thunderbirds got on the board first. 15:05, time of the goal. Panacek from Ford and Pastuka kicked off the scoring. That was a power play goal and came as part of a major power play for the Thunderbirds early in that, I should say late in that first period. And that got the ball rolling. It was 1-0 after one. In the second, the River Dragons got the offense to come alive a little bit. 9:11, time of the goal for Ryan Hunter. His first as a pro, ties it at one. Alex Storjahan, the only assist on the goal, as Hunter wires one over the right shoulder of the goaltender Mario Cavalieri to knot things up. Then Alexander Jemayev's team-leading eighth goal of the year from Wickline and Gill at 18:29 before the end of the period. And the River Dragons took a 2-1 lead into the dressing room 40 minutes in. As they did last night, however, the Thunderbirds tied things up late in this one. It wasn't quite the final minute, and the goaltender was not pulled, but a nice setup in the slot and kind of finding his way free in traffic. Dawson Baker was all alone between the hash marks. Gus Ford fed him for the one-time release at 15:29 that beats Taylor Joseph. Knots the game of two and into overtime we go. River Dragons start with possession in the overtime. They did not generate a scoring chance though, and back down the other way it went. Gus Ford was stopped on a first wraparound attempt, went back behind the net, wrapped it around a second time. This time it goes in for the game winner. Salak and Boutita, the assist at 42 seconds of the OT, and the Thunderbirds skate off with the extra point in overtime here tonight. Shots by period for the River Dragons, 12 in the first, 13 in the second, 10 in the third for a total of 35, none in the overtime. Carolina 8, 18, 7, and just that one shot credited in overtime for 34, but that shot is the game winner. And the Carolina Thunderbirds win 3-2 here tonight in the OT against the River Dragons. All right, we've got one more look back at that Zelmo Zippin' Out of Town scoreboard for you. Stay tuned. That's coming up on the other side of the break as we wrap things up here from the annex at Winston-Salem Fairgrounds. We'll be right back with more in a moment on Columbus River Dragons Hockey.
Announcing Wade Cleaner's newest location at 6801 River Road, located just across from the new VA hospital. This location has a drive-through and is open 6 days a week. Tell us you heard this and receive 25% off your first visit. Wade Cleaner's, since 1939.
We know that juicy, cheesy, grilled to perfection burger sounds amazing, but it does sound like something is missing. Pepsi, baby! The yin to this burger's yang. Burgers and Pepsi go together like, well, like burgers and Pepsi. This perfect blending of flavors makes every bite of lettuce, every sesame seed on the bun, and every sip of that crisp, refreshing, ice-cold cola a journey to Foodtopia. Burgers, better with Pepsi. That's what I like.
At the Country Inn and Suites by Radisson, you'll enjoy comfortable accommodations close to Columbus State University, Fort Benning, and of course, the River Dragons games. Conveniently located at 1720 Fountain Court in Columbus, you'll be minutes away from all your favorite Columbus destinations. Free high-speed Wi-Fi and hot breakfast always available too. So whether you're staying for business or for pleasure, make your next stay in Columbus a comfortable one at the official hotel partner of the River Dragons. Country Inn and Suites by Radisson.
Vector Ply Corporation is a world-leading manufacturer of carbon, fiberglass, and Kevlar composite fabrics located in Phenix City, Alabama. Our customers depend on us to produce iconic brands such as Malibu and Nautique Boat and the historic C8 mid-engine Corvette. Even the light poles surrounding the Columbus Civic Center were produced by a Vector Ply customer using Vector Ply fabrics. If you're looking for an exciting career with a growing manufacturer located right here in the Chattahoochee Valley, visit our website, vectorply.com.
I love the way they all doubt me. That's the energy that I need.
And we are back to wrap things up here one more time for the broadcast location in the annex, Winston-Salem Fairgrounds. Tom Callahan here with you. Thank you so much for sticking around with us here as we have one more look at the Zelmo Zip and Out of Town scoreboard. We're one of five games going on in the league here tonight. And no real surprise at this one, but the Motor City Rockers 7-2, the final over the Elmira River Sharks. They built a 5-0 lead 10 minutes into the first period. Motor City never looked back in that one. Meanwhile, the Binghamton Black Bears right now with a 3-2 lead over the Danbury Hattricks as that one moves into third period action. Also moving into the third period, you've got the Port Huron Prowlers with a 4-2 lead over the Mississippi Seawolves. And at the end of the first, the Baton Rouge Zydeco have a 1-0 lead over the Blue Ridge Bobcats. NHL out of town for you. Finals from earlier today. Rangers 7-4 over the Bruins. Kings blank the Canadiens 4-0. Devils 5-1 over the Sabres after two periods of play. After two, the Penguins have come back to lead the Leafs 3-2. Scoreless midway through the second between the Flyers and the Islanders. 10 o'clock Eastern time starts for the Flames at Avalanche, Canucks at Sharks, and Coyotes at Golden Knights. And then to wrap things up one more time in the scoreboard of college football for you on an incredibly important day. A lot of finals from earlier. Number 15, Arizona, 59-23 over Arizona State. Other games final. Number 3, Michigan beats number 2, Ohio State, 30-24. Number 4, Washington holds on against Washington State, 24-21. Number 8, Alabama needed a last-minute touchdown, but they beat Auburn in the Iron Bowl 27-24. Kentucky upsets number 10 Louisville 38-31 tonight. Number 14 LSU 42-30 winners over Texas A&M. It took double overtime, but number 20 Oklahoma State escapes BYU 40-34. Number 21 Tennessee doubles up Vanderbilt tonight 48-24. Number 25 Liberty 42-28 winners over UTEP. Games going on right now in college football at the half. Florida still leading number 5 Florida State. It's 12-7. Number 18 Notre Dame has a 28-16 lead over Stanford. Number 1 Georgia up 21-13 on Georgia Tech. That's late in the second. Also late in the second, number 24 Clemson 13-7 over South Carolina. Number 19 Kansas State trails Iowa State just into the second quarter 14-6. And number 22, NC State with a 13-0 lead over North Carolina in the second quarter of that one. Well, that's going to wrap it up for us here in the Pepsi postgame show. The River Dragons will now come back home tonight and have a week of practice at home before getting out on the road to take on the Blue Ridge Bobcats for the first time in franchise history. Both of those games will be in Wytheville, Virginia. Next River Dragons home games, December 8th and 9th. It's going to be a party weekend. On the 8th, mascot birthday bash, scorch and torch, celebrate a birthday. And then on the 9th, the 5th anniversary party for the River Dragons. So I hope you're able to join us for those. We look forward to seeing you then. And in the meantime, if you need tickets, head over to Ticketmaster.com for single game seats, or you can always go to rdragons.com for schedule. group information. Full seasons are still available. We'll talk to you about it. We'll let you know the best we can do for you, and we hope that you come down and enjoy River Dragons hockey. One more time, your final here in overtime tonight. The Carolina Thunderbirds 3-2 winners over the Columbus River Dragons. My thanks to Drew Pierce for producing tonight. I'm Tom Callahan. Thanks so much for joining us. You've been listening to and watching Columbus River Dragons hockey.
Thank you for being a part of Columbus River Dragons hockey. This game was brought to you in part by Pepsi, the official soft drink of the Columbus River Dragons. Zelmo Zip-In, the official fuel provider of the River Dragons. Air Force Heating and Air, the official heating and air company of the River Dragons. Country Inn and Suites, the official host hotel of the River Dragons. And by Chick-fil-A Midland, Tim Hortons, Columbus Diagnostic, Shredaway, the Overby Company, Vector Ply, Trivioli's, The Jersey Shop, Beam TV, WYBU Christian Television Network, Troy University, Largeman Dental, BKI Accounting, The Optical Shop, Piggly Wiggly, Sun South John Deere, Wade Cleaners, Houston Clinic, Abercrombie Bonding, First Franklin Financial, and Old School Barbershop. This has been a presentation of Ignite Sports and Entertainment. Any rebroadcast, retransmission, or any other use is prohibited without the express written consent of Ignite Sports and Entertainment and the Columbus River Dragons. This has been a presentation of the Columbus River Dragons.